Stunning afternoon here in Canberra, as you mentioned, at Star Trek Oval. Tony Shaw and Cameron Mooney alongside me. Before we even get a word from them, I'm going to introduce the coach of the Melbourne Football Club. He's been good enough to give us a little bit of time before his team does go out to do battle with the Giants. Welcome to you, Roosie.
Thanks, boys. Yeah, thank you.
Now, a great win last week. What was it about the performance that impressed you the most?
Oh, probably the fact that they came at us three times. I think they got to 11, 12 and then 8 in the last quarter, and we were able to steady. Last year we weren't able to do that often enough, and I think the fact that we probably played our best two-way game, we were able to limit their score somewhat.
Yep.
And able to kick a good score ourselves.
Aurelio Lumumba, I thought he was fantastic. You talk about stoppages. One thing, the package now that he looked like a genuine midfielder other than a half-back flanker, but gee, I saw him giving instructions, great leadership.
Yeah, look, he's been terrific since he's been at the footy club, and I think obviously people sort of see him as that half-back type, but we've played him a lot through the middle of ground. He played a little bit of wing, obviously, at Collingwood, but look, his size, he's sort of the prototype, you know, modern-day midfielder. You know, 6'2", good size, good speed, and he tends to keep us going forward, which is really important.
Roosie, I reckon January, you probably wouldn't have had Aaron Vandenberg passing into your number one, into your round one team. Had a great pre-season, had a great round one. Tell us about this kid.
Yeah, look, we scouted him last year, and the recruiters did, came to our attention, they showed us the vision. Yeah, I suppose when a 22, 23-year-old comes in, you're not necessarily expecting them to play straight away, but they don't have to develop their body. Came in with a shoulder reco, was slow but worked really hard, and then once we sort of saw him training, you could realise why he was getting 50 possessions in the NFL, and then he played some practice games, got really good habits, good size again, good speed, good endurance, and sort of forced his way in because of his performance.
Well, we've just seen the Giants make their way out onto Star Trek Oval. You've had a hit with every recruit you picked up because Jeffy Garlett made a stunning debut for the club last week. I think he was second in the competition for scoring assists. He was involved in everything. You couldn't have been happy with his performance, surely.
Yeah, look, he was really good, really important for us. You know, there was a centre clearance. He went in the centre bounce, kicked the goal out of the centre clearance and stemmed the momentum. I thought his tackle pressure was just outstanding. Yeah. His ability to put inferred pressure and also make tackles was really telling for us.
They go deep in the midfield. Who do you tag? Who do you go with? Griffin, Treloar, Whitfield, Chip?
Yeah, they've got a really deep midfield, haven't they?
So I think Griffin your target, you think?
Probably Griffin on the back of last week, but it frees up other players, and I'm sure the other guys, you know, the other Giants guys will be looking around saying, oh, I hope he goes to Griffin. So, yeah, look, we'll probably start with him, but it's all the midfield working together to try and beat this team.
Some of those young blokes are getting a free ride, Roosie, not getting tagged. You need to introduce them to what the game's all about. Hey, how are the confidence levels for you now that you've spent a bit more time at the club, you've started the season the right way? How confident are you that they will start to produce the same sort of intensity and quality of effort on a weekly basis?
Yeah, I think that's what today's about, Jase. You know, we played really well. The best game we've played since I've been there. We had some really good wins last year, but four quarters was a good performance. Today's a real test for us, so we haven't been able to do that consistently, and I think we'll be able to answer those questions after the game a bit better.
Roosie, really appreciate your time. You're always generous. Good luck today. Let's hope the D's get off to a flyer in 2015.
Thanks, guys. Yeah, appreciate it. Thanks,
mate. In the meantime, we'll take a look at the two lineups, starting with the D's. Shorey, what do you make of the lineup? It's starting to look better on paper, isn't it?
Well, their defence with Garland, McDonald. I think Tom McDonald's one of the best defenders in the competition. Yep. Lyndon Dunn's gone back there to bolster that area. And Frost has been a good inclusion. Good to see Bernie Vince and Chris Dawes come back in. I think they just add to that senior part of this group. It was fairly young, but gee, they had some experience, which they probably need. And Jack Watts, gee, he was fantastic early last week.
He was. Angus Brayshaw will start as the sub. The Giants, well, they beat St Kilda last week, Moons, but I didn't think they were super impressive.
No, they weren't super. Look, Hampton out and Wilson coming in as a sub. But look, I love the fact that Patfield's back in the side now. It really strengthens up that back line. Davis, Haynes, I'm really looking forward to see who they all match up with. Look, Ward through the middle of the ground, and they've got such young talent. But it's their forward line that I love. Sorry, Jeremy Cameron needs to get his hands on the ball more, and McCarthy's the other one. 7 goals between them last week.
Well, Cameron only had 6 possessions, 4 goals too. It's not bad efficiency, is it?
Look, yeah, but he's getting them all in the attacking 50. At some stage,
you've got to move up.
If you're not getting enough ball and you're not making the most of each and every opportunity, you're going to have some really dry days. So he's got to start going further afield, surely.
Look, he only averaged the 9 possessions last year, and speaking to the coach just before the game, they want to see him up around the logos. Yep. They want to see him get his 13 to 15 possessions for a game. That's going to make him more dangerous. He'll still get his 4 or 5 shots on goal, no question about it.
And what we want to see is a cracking match. It's the Giants and the D's. They're ready to go at Star Trek Oval. A perfect day for footy. Join Anthony Hudson for the first bounce on the other side of the break.
Two clash between two sides that had round one victories, Melbourne and GWS. Of course, the Giants beating the Saints by 9 points and the Demons beating the Gold Coast by 26 points. These two sides have met six times in all, and it's 3-3. So we should be in for a close one. Jason Dunstall and Tony Shaw have joined us up in the commentary position as the two captains make their way to the middle. Cal Ward and Nathan Jones with the honours this afternoon. And you were just saying, boys, as you came up, it really is quite warm out there.
It is. Well, the sun's shining, very, very warm. And as soon as the cloud comes over, you would probably say it is perfect conditions for football.
Amazing. And as you said, fairly warm, but I think we should see some very good football.
And Callan Ward won the toss. The coin today being tossed is part of the official Anzac coin collection from the Royal Australian Mint. And it's only available with the Daily Telegraph, Herald Sun and other News Corp newspapers from this weekend. A great way to remember and celebrate the Anzac story. So who are you actually going for, Jason?
I gave it great consideration because I liked what Melbourne brought to the table last week, but I stuck with GWS. I didn't think they were overly impressive last week, but they did dominate in the midfield, and I think they've got perhaps a little more depth there, and that might be enough to supply that forward line.
Let's get down to Cameron Mooney.
Thank you very much, Hutto. Yes, beautiful day here in Canberra, though. Not a wind either, guys. It's absolutely spectacular. Look, big day for both clubs. We know that GWS haven't won the first two rounds in their short history at the moment. And look, Melbourne, they haven't won the first two rounds since 2005. And who's to start with? Well, it starts with these big men in the middle, Jamar and Mumford. 207 kilos between them, absolutely crashing in on this first one. Really excited about what we're going to see from these two big men. We know Mummy's coming off a great year of best and fairest last year. Jamar, All-Australian 2010. I think last week he got a little bit of that form back, boys. Looking forward to this one.
Good stuff, Moons. The Giants, of course, this is part of their home ground, if you like. They play usually three games here. Last year they lost all three of their games up here, so they really want to start making this something that other teams don't want to come and play them here.
Yeah, I'm not sure they've built it into a home ground advantage of any sort just yet. I don't judge it by that record you're talking about.
One out of nine it is.
But look, that's going to come with the natural improvement that they show from season to season.
Some of those matchups will be interesting, won't they? Haynes looks like he's on Frost, who might be starting forward along with Dawes and Hogan. So they're going quite tall. Watts is also inside that forward half. There's Lumumba out on the wing.
And Jack Viney's gone straight to Griffin, Hutto. So we thought that might happen. Well, hard day at the office for Griffin.
He did an outstanding job last week on Gary Ablett. Round two from Star Trek Oval in Canberra. It doesn't begin in the most glorious fashion with a pretty crooked bounce.
GWS.
So Tom McDonald's got the job on Jeremy Cameron. He's the one that's going to go there. Colin Garland goes to McCarthy.
And Tomlinson also deep. Goes over his head. Dunn's watching him. We see McDonald and Cameron come into focus. Demons are able to crash through. Donald's kick hack back to the middle. Very much up for grabs. Flicked out by Cornelio, who gets a start this week. He was the sub last. Knocked back, well done by Cross. Put the spoil on Kelly and then earned himself a free. So Daniel Cross, the now experienced and wily midfielder for the D's. Chipped it forward, wasn't the best of kicks. Dawes was the target. It was only a short pass, and there's plenty of Giants to help Phil Davis out, and they'll, well, almost get it out, but Shaw decided he'd actually kick it out in the full.
Big job for Thomas Bug today. We saw him involved in a clash with Nick Revolt last week, albeit an accidental one, but he's got the shutdown job on Jeff Garlett, and he is constantly on the move as we speak.
So Daniel Cross busy this early stage. Sets this one well up into the air. Davis and Dawes and Haynes was the man who went up unencumbered to take the mark. Well, the other two were pushing and shoving. He was prominent early last week, wasn't he, Haynes, in the first quarter? Keeps it moving again through Kelly and now Shaw as they collaborate on that outer half back flank. Tom Scully getting some hoots from his former supporters who have made the journey up here to Canberra to watch today.
They've got long memories, haven't they? Couple of years now, so they still hold a grudge.
Tell to forget. Tell me, will it be any different when Frost gets a touch? How will the supporters of GWS?
Probably a less controversial
I think so.
So both sides just feeling each other out at this early stage. Jamar and Mumford, we talked about what a big pivotal role that'll be. And it's Ward to take it, just changed his mind midstream. Gets it back from Buck. Hasn't got himself into the clear yet. Kelly, and they've been pushed back to half-back, and then Shaw, trusting his skills, good strong lead. Pushing up Patful. And good attentive defence from Garland, sees it over the line. He's playing on McCarthy. It's not a bad young defence, is it? I know they've lost Frawley, but McDonald is a really good type, and Garland as well, pretty experienced now.
Well, Dunn's always gone back. He played up forward a bit last year, so he's the man who's pushed back there.
Well, this is the beauty of Garland. McCarthy's just run off after that spoil, and then Chalor's come on, and now he's picking up Chalor. So his ability to play on the talls and smalls is so important for Melbourne.
Looks like Ward's got a really close rein over Nathan Jones. He'll be keeping him tight if he can. Griffin getting that treatment from Viney that Ablett felt last week. Tyson's another former Giant. Now, Shaw sends it forward with some purpose. He was in the minority there, was Cameron. Palmer goes to ground, and he's caught one.
Did a good job then, Reece Palmer. Yep. Kept that ball alive, and then he's been a very good player. Good find from a goal-kicking defensive forward, small forward. He likes to sneak a goal now and then.
Tell you what he does do, Shaw, is he puts himself in a lot of good positions. Mm. He reads the play well. And it looked like he might have been trying to pay attention to Jeremy Howe earlier on when the first bounce started as well, so we'll keep an eye on that.
Has a record of kicking goals against the Demons too.
It's a unique starting position for his goal kicking, isn't it? Almost like the goal kicker's in rugby.
He's on his way. Let's see if it works.
No, there
won't be too many copying him if he keeps going with that form. But we did see it last week. Kick one goal, two. He has the legs sort of wide apart, doesn't he, as he lines it up and then brings them closer together.
That's called a shank.
horrible.
Get back across,
Daniel. Thank you. Daniel Cross getting in the right place at the moment for kicks out on the full. That's his second already. You take that. Goes short to McDonald. They still haven't cleared the defensive goal square at this stage. It's been a relatively sedate start to this game as McDonald sends it out to the wing. Strong body work and beautiful leap from Patful, not rewarded by the umpire. Okay, he was closer than we were.
It's a good positive decision. He said he saw it hit the ground, so he very quickly called play on. And he's right.
No.
Really good decision.
Griffin tried to get a run at it. Salem was there for the Demons. Jetta pushed into the turf. Crowd still filling their way in. It is Star Trek Oval. Ball close to the line. Kept in by Tyson along the boundary. Sits up, tough for Dawes. He knew, bracing himself for the contact. It came straight away from Davis. Now the scramble continues. Shaw looked up. He only saw opposition jumpers. And he did pretty well to disguise that.
Great work there from Dawes, boys. He was 2-on-1, made sure the ball at least got to ground, and just then followed up with a great tackle. Fantastic start from Dawes.
Back in the team, of course, after suspension last week. Chris Dawes, Frost, Canelio. Again, now Bernie Vince. He's also returned to the Melbourne lineup. To half forward, Patful left, Watts. Knocked it to ground. Davis flicked it out to Haynes. Screws it back to half forward. Mumford has to go and he knows. He got the hand up and brought it to ground, but it's all Melbourne there. Jetta. Not a pleasant thought being crunched by Shane Mumford.
And it's why you love him, isn't it?
You take
that free kick if you're Leon Cameron. You take that. Not a problem.
He makes a statement with the aggression, doesn't he?
Thanks. Stay there.
Looking at both sides or both teams behind play, no one's got a definite plus one. So it's just man on man all around the ground.
Well, both sides finding it hard to penetrate at the moment, despite that. And Green works it, uses Bug. His options all dried up, so he maintained possession. Green is the one that kicks it in the Cameron direction.
Well done.
And McDonald takes it away from him.
I think Tom McDonald's moved up into maybe the top six or one of the top six best defenders in the competition, boys. He's got closing speed, good body size. And I think he's going to be a leader of this club.
Tomlinson in the ruck, but it got through to Green. Good scramble tackle from Vince. Again, well restrained, and no one's finding possessions easy at all here.
At the other end, you mentioned the contest between Patful and Watts. I really like that matchup for GWS. Very creative player, Watts. They put Joel Patful on him to shut him down.
Frost and now Vandenberg in his hometown, or at least the town where he was playing for Ainslie, and made his mark. We all heard Paul Roos talk about it pre-match. They were watching him last year, were suitably impressed.
And there's the matchup you were discussing, Jace. Yep. Patford and Watts.
No easy kicks there.
7.5 minutes gone in the opening term and no score so far. Mumford out-muscled Frost on that occasion. Brought it to his feet. Salem with the slick hands. Cross, they keep it moving. Viney took a step to balance himself. The kick, though, in the end, didn't have a lot of penetration on it. And they walk that fine line.
Close.
Aiden Corr takes it over, according to the boundary umpire. Disposals for the Giants, 18 for Melbourne. No free kick played, no whistle. Cross has been very busy accumulating possessions. Canelio took it from Shaw.
Good kick.
That's a great kick.
Finds Palmer. Shields scooting by. Shields was excellent last week. It's a handball again. Kelly linking up with Whitfield. His kick for Cameron. Well, he's pushed further up the ground. You guys were talking about last week how all his possessions were inside 50. He's kicked this one towards full forward. Lumumba has to go again. They're circling here. Green. It was the quickest kick you've ever seen, but it doesn't result in anything other than a Melbourne possession, and it's Kent.
I just wonder whether they've identified with Lumumba, if they can get him to the goal square. He wasn't comfortable his last couple of years at Collingwood doing that role.
How? Out to the wing.
They're out.
And Hogan can go to Watts, and Newton's all on his own inside 50, and he waits a pleasant few seconds for the ball to arrive. And then he can pop it over the top. And McDonald's come all the way down from defence. Well worked, Demons.
Great running. He's made Jeremy Cameron follow him all the way down, but he didn't quite get there, so he gets a chance to put a goal against Jeremy Cameron and really put the wind up him.
As you know, Jace, there's nothing worse when your bloke runs all the way down. You're just hoping someone might get him in the meantime. But unfortunately, it didn't happen for Jeremy Cameron there.
2.4 is his career tally, but Tom McDonald very assured as he rams it through for the first.
And plenty of Melbourne players go over and give it to Jeremy Cameron, the umpire, quickly in to break it up. Look, we spoke about Jeremy Cameron pre-game. Got all his possessions inside the attacking 50. Well, we wanted him further afield, but this isn't the way he wants to get dragged out of the attacking 50 zone. So it was terrific offensive running from Tom McDonald, who just kept going, pushing forward. And he got the benefits from it, and there is no better way to stop a forward kicking goals than taking him out of that area.
First goal took 10 minutes, and it was from the boot of Tom McDonald, the full back moons. Down to you.
It was, hello, Reese. Got down here, Reese Palmer, Reese. Fantastic stuff from both teams. Really tough conditions at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah, two teams desperate to win their second game for the year, mate. So hopefully it's like this the whole day, and we'll definitely set ourselves for a big day.
Yourself, just a nice little shot there on goal. Just couldn't quite get that one.
Yeah, mate, I'll miss one here and there, but hopefully make up for it the rest of the
day. I'm sure you'll race. Good on you, mate. Thanks for your time.
Thank you, Moons. They're inside again. You heard the call from the umpire. Dawes, beautifully shot. Kent. And he's got enough curl on it for a goal. And that's two for the Demons.
Well done to Dean Kent. Gee, good to see front and centre. Someone we don't see a lot of because there's so many numbers behind the ball, but just a quick kick forward and the clearance, and that's what you want to see. Try and get a one-on-one. And he worked it really well then. Or was that Dawes who worked to the front then, boys, I think? But Kent beautifully worked off the front of this pack here. It was Dawes. Oh, kept the ball alive beautifully.
So even though the inside 50s are level and the Giants have had more possessions, it's the Demons with the only two goals in this game so far. In brilliant sunshine in Canberra. Viney back to Salem. They work well together. Wasn't a perfect handball. Put him off balance a little bit, but not a problem in the end. Tyson to centre half forward. Garlett takes it. Glances inside the 50. Hogan wants to go one way. Doubles back. Just had to pause and make his lead as the kick came in from Garlett in the end to full forward. And Kent again.
Well, right now, Melbourne's working harder than GWS. They're running both ways. They're pushing really hard when they win possession in the middle of the ground, and too many of the Giants players are spectating and not paying attention to the Melbourne opponents that are running forward into space. We just saw him hard running get rewarded a moment ago when he rove the ball off the pack and kicked a terrific goal, gets a chance to kick two in a couple of minutes. This is a fantastic start for the Ds.
Dean Kemp, who copped that blow early from Matt Shaw last week. He's kicked one goal already. Comes in. Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
Oh, that hurts, doesn't it?
Yep. Did everything right. Worked hard. Needed to reward himself and his team.
Let him run. Jeff Devon. Cut it out.
He must have done that from midfield too, Kemp, because he's gone straight to Callum Ward as trying to man up. And now he's that man right here now. And there's Kent in the back. Give a free kick away.
Toby Green went by hand. Whitfield had to rush it onto the boot. Smith, I should say, up to half forward. McDonald tries to chop across you. They both ran past it there. Excellent hands from Treloar. Opened up Tomlinson. Good running from Smith. He got the kick off half back, and here he is inside 50. Overwhelmed by the numbers. Frosson, great agility for a big man. Trots away with it. Wasn't the best of kicks, though. Newton's got a bit of a challenge because there was Giants flying from both sides, and Haynes was fully committed. Takes it over the line and out of bounds.
How good was Viney on Devon Smith there? I mean, that wasn't his man, but he ran him down, put pressure on, and stopped a potential goal for the Giants.
Well, they need something here, the Giants. Melbourne with the first three scoring shots. Have a couple of goals. Really should be a three-goal margin, but that easy shot for goal missed. Nathan Jones must be delighted with Melbourne's improvements in the off-season and can get some more joy into his footy now, he'll be hoping.
He deserves a bit of excitement, doesn't he?
He does.
He's worked so hard for so long.
Kelly with the run around. Scully found a passage eventually. Shaw to full forward. Double fisted. No chances taken from Garland, but they're on the board.
I like the pressure that Melbourne are putting around the ball. They're not allowing the Giants time to link up, shoot a couple of hand passes out and dispose without pressure.
So Garland's ready. Ball curls in the air a bit. Davis got there and Hogan both missed it, but Palmer didn't. Snaffled it well and pops it out in front.
Oh,
McCarthy.
Arms, was it?
Well, it was
should have marked it.
Should have marked it anyway.
He lays a good tackle, so it's good follow-up from McCarthy, but he'd be frustrated with that.
Got to mark those.
Perfect kick for Reece Palmer. I thought he set it up beautifully. He dropped the ball.
Yeah, no free kick there.
It was really impressive last week, McCarthy, but still a young man. Ward got one in the back, really. Sure, that is a rainmaker. Alan Lumumba was the man that wanted it most. Takes it and the D's can break. Cross, delicate little pass to McDonald. They start the spread further wide now. Watts has got it, he'll know where Dawes is. Pushing hard inside 50. He was patient though. And he showed good restraint because eventually the lead there materialised from Kent. And he takes the mark 75 out from goal. Davis, was he hanging on? Pretty sure Dawes was making sure the umpire knew about it.
He had a hold of the jumper, no doubt about it. But Dean Kent, boys, he's either coming out of the midfield, pushing forward, really pushing up the ground. Yeah, had a handful of jumper.
Didn't
but he's a dangerous
either.
Option across half forward.
He actually didn't need to because he was under the football, Dawes.
Kicked 20 goals in 2014. His most since 27 in 2011.
See that great tactic there, Hutto? If you want a little bit more time to take the kick, just do your shoelace up. They blow time off.
You can see the task for him, just to nurse it through. Across it goes. 2-2-14 in Melbourne. And the Giants, one behind. What do we think so far, boys?
Well, one thing, Ryan Griffin has not touched the ball. Matter of fact, when he came back on the ground, he went to full forward. So they've had a win there already, Melbourne.
Aiden Cord just came off the bench, was all on his own on the opposite flank. Heath Shaw didn't have a look, didn't see him. And he's kicked it out of bounds on the other side. They should have been away there, the Giants.
Instead, Jesse Hogan sends the Demons with a low ball into the 50. Dawes and Davis both had their claims on it. Sure, he's kicked another one out of the foot. No, it was touched.
Touched off the boot. I'll tell you what, if I'm Leon Cameron, I'm really worried right now. They weren't impressive last week, and they've started in the same fashion today, the Giants. They're getting out-bustled, out-worked. The pressure from the Ds, they're just showing more desperation, more commitment at the moment.
The rucks arrive. Jamar and Mumford. Jamar took the prime position. Yep, he's got a free. That's coming back to big mark Jamar.
Well, at least you know one thing. The Melbourne forward line looks a lot more dangerous than GWS every time they go inside 50. Whether it's talls or at ground level, it just looks dangerous.
So he decides to go all the way back to the middle to Tom McDonald. He'll look for a different avenue to attack. As Dunn trying to decide whether to go to the left wing or the right wing, which is pretty important here in Canberra. Oh, there's almost a turnover. As McDonald goes back to retrieve it. Little short pass from Dunn to Jetta. Just forward of the centre. Looking to link up and run. Viney hesitated. Well, he really kept Palmer guessing. Did well. Drives into the pocket. And Dawes thought he was going under the ball and turned his back on it. And that was a pretty easy mark for Phil Davis. Well done. Just not convincing at the moment on the way out.
No.
Kelly bundled away. Palmer caught one. Hogan, get out of my way sort of stuff. High ball again. Bit of space junk there for Davis to keep his eye on, and it comes down and he goes short, too short. McCarthy, he was rounded up by Watts but broke the tackle. Pivotal, and that's a big kick into the middle. Just it was too strong for Mumford.
Yeah.
And that, well, that's pushing the umpire. That was very nearly 50.
Again, just look, they both misjudged the ball. Jamar didn't need to do anything in the end because Mumford had run under the ball.
He was
they've split the lines here.
Desperate to lay it off, which he did. Whitfield, powerful kick.
Poor kick.
Too rushed in the end, wasn't it?
It was a poor kick. Cameron's dirty. He's given him a little spray. He was leading out to the side and he's kicked it back into the corridor where the two Melbourne players were.
Short again to Garland. T's lead by 13. They're leading the contested possessions, 22 to 19. Newton. Melbourne also winning the clearances, 9 to 4. And they're dominating those harder areas of the game. Canelio. Haynes was about to be tackled by Jones. Given a lot of luxury and latitude by the umpire. Could have been deep holding the ball. Oh,
they messed that up.
They did. Garland was the culprit, unaware of the position Salem was in. Now Whitfield, as they can link up. Green, kick it into the space. Tomlinson, McDonald tries to track it back.
Oh,
and he did a marvellous job. And well done, Tom McDonald.
How good is that spoil?
You might have him in your top three by the end of the day, sure.
Well, he had to avoid contact because in the slightest bit of contact forward like that when you're running with the ball as a free kick, that is magnificent.
Great to watch. Lumumba heaves the kick out to the wing. Finds Bernie Vince.
Something Tomlinson will have to learn, though, Jace. All he had to do was stop, prop, and he would have taken the hit and he would have got a free kick straight away.
And he stabs the pass for Vandenberg.
They just look more controlled in general play, don't they? They look like, you know, they are hitting the targets fairly well. Melbourne, then they turn one over like that. But they have looked like they've controlled general play better.
And that's out on the full. That was a bit wasteful. Interesting, the kick handball ratio. The Giants have had more handballs than kicks, and that was a problem for them last week, Jace, with their midfield.
Yep, absolutely. We're seeing it again.
Melbourne, on the other hand, 44 kicks and 16 handballs. So they're really using their feet a lot more than their hands.
And as a general rule, you will do more damage with the foot.
Ryan Griffin at last, a possession. So there's upside. That's the one thing for the Giants. You've got Griffin now with one possession or about to have one possession. Dylan Scheel, who was good last week, he's only had one possession so far.
Well, this is a dangerous kick. If this is a turnover, there's three Melbourne players here.
Yeah, Green had to fight the fight in his own. Salem sweeping in. Handball to Frost. Had a little glance behind as a penetrating handball into the path for Jones. And then to Kent. He's got one. He's missed one. And that's not a great kick either. Courageous stuff from Joel Patful. Still up for grabs, though. McCarthy's been redeployed into defence again. And Kent walks it over.
Is that making great decisions with the ball at the moment, the Giants? That kick coming out of defence there to a badly outnumbered contest.
Well grabbed by Jamer! Oh, you're having some sort of a day where the ruckman can do that.
Well, let's have a look at this. Oh, Mummy just missed the body totally, and Jamer then. Great snap from a big bloke, and as you said, luck's a fortune. I think he probably kicked one out of ten in doing that. But, gee, Shane Muffet got to make better body contact, at least get to the contest. Look, he looks red here, misses it, and he's out of the contest totally.
Astonishing start by the Demons here. They're dominating. They lead by 18 points.
Most of the stats are very similar. The one that stands out at the moment, clearances. 10-4 in favour of the Ds. So they're getting first use of the footy from the stoppages.
They almost were away again. Dylan Shield tries to reverse that trend. They link up well, Scully and Ward. They're inside. And good sliding lead from Cameron. Enough. No.
Oh, hold on.
Cameron thinks he's having a shot for goal.
Well, the umpire did pay something. He can't just pay...
He can't believe it, Jeremy Cameron. He's going, what?
He's changed his mind then. He thought he had marked it, but then changed it.
Play on then,
no, I think you do have the power of the umpire to in that situation, so I made a mistake.
Yeah, and I think because some of the players stopped when they heard the whistle.
Jamar fended it away. Tyson, been prominent again, just hacked it out of there. But...
He changed it quick, though, didn't he? Like, you know, normally you just let it play on and see what... But he probably thought it might have disadvantaged, as Jason said, one side or the other, because they all had stopped.
Shield. It's very crowded inside the 50.
Yeah, that's where Melbourne's outworking GWS. They're getting all the numbers back behind the footy, and they're creating turnovers.
Yeah, Garland was able to work the angle. Or now he's playing a bit of solo action out there. And... He got himself into all sorts of trouble. They rip it away. McCarthy, Shield.
Oh, he dragged that in.
So, yep.
Yep. And I think that's what the Giants need a bit here, isn't it? They need to win some of those tight contests. You mentioned the clearances and the contested possessions.
Oh, what about that for a kick?
So he's handed both his possessions back, Dylan Shield. After trying to get into the contest. Cross and the Demons... prepared to hang on to the ball here.
Well, they've got to hold up here because if you look down the ground, there's about four or five GWS defenders just in a line. So they'll just play possession footy, tempo football here for the next minute to see if they can break the lines.
They've just got no spark out here at the moment, John.
You can even
just sense it down here that the torque's not there, the aggression around the football's not there at the moment. They're getting beaten up around stoppages, as you said, Jase. Even when it goes into their back line, you just don't feel the urgency in their backs to try and win the ball back.
It looks flat on every front from a Giants perspective at the moment. Ideally love a goal before quarter time.
Close to the line, Griffin and Ward. They keep it in, or do they? No, they don't. Last year, of course, GWS had two wins over the Demons. They beat them by 47 points in round 21. Melbourne kicked 3 goals, 16 that day. And earlier in the year in round 4, they beat them by 32 points. But this is a different Melbourne lineup now. Griffin finding the footy, but again, very systematic in the way it comes forward. It bounces before it goes over, though. That's the good news for the Giants. And we'll have a throw-in. But they are goalless after 25 and a half minutes in beautiful conditions. In Canberra. Unseasonably warm. Boundary throw in. Frost over the top, the third up was Ward. This is Jones now. Had a little bit of leeway. Salem didn't have any leeway at all. But Scully wasn't able to restrain him completely. So the Ds keep it in their hands. And they can run and share it around. Newton gives it to Lumumba. The legs were pumping. Just had to wait a fraction longer than he wanted to. And there's a fumble they couldn't afford. Shaw takes it back from Kent. And now he marches through the middle of Star Trek Oval. Onto the left, Cameron. He was a little uncomfortable, so he handballs. Gets it back from Griffin. Overruns it. They continue to be scrappy and untidy. And Jones takes it away to Frost. Spears it to the wing. No mark. Dawes was handcuffed. But again, a fumble at the crucial moment. And the tackle wasn't completed either. Griffin to stand, start, then back. Kelly to find his teammate in Ward. Here's Bug, come up and take it. Griffin again, he's starting to win the ball, Griffin, that's something.
Yeah, but the only thing is it's deep across half back. They need him to drive through the forward 50 to get over the top of the line. This is, they kick to these one-on-one contests every time it's in our forward.
Yeah, and Melbourne have manned up beautifully. Yeah, they don't allow any free Giants, no... Simple kicks, no maintaining possession.
Too strong, too tall. Chris Dawes takes the mark.
really like Melbourne's setup at the moment, Jace. You've got Vandenberg and Watts, your mobile forwards. Then you've got Dawes, who just saw their big contested mark. He's crash and bash. And Hogan, well, Hogan, we know, can do it all.
It's a good mix, isn't it? Oh, that's 50. Well, Phil Davis is a little unlucky here because I think he feels he got the first touch on that. I reckon he's pretty keen on the fact that he had his hands on it first. Maybe as the man in front before it was taken away by Hogan, but this will be a certain goal.
If it was cricket, he would refer that, wouldn't he? I mean, you're right. I mean, his body language was all that he had got substantial contact onto it. But it's not cricket, and he can't refer it. And Melbourne should have four goals before the Giants have kicked any late in the first quarter as Jesse Hogan rubs it in a little more.
Well, Cam Mooney was just talking about the mix they've got up forward. It looks so much better when you've got a couple of tall key position players, a couple of tallish mobile third option styles. As we have a look at the replay, you can see he had fingers on it. But I've got no problem with the mark being paid as well. They kind of did it at the same time. And there's only one bloke controlling the footy, and that's Jesse Hogan. But it does touch the fingertips.
Oh, I reckon that's Davis. Touch. That is play on. Because it's gone through him as in the front player. Might have thought it was stiff there.
Should the umpire just give him a little bit of the benefit then?
Oh, it's tough. To see that it was touched by the fingertips just as it was entering the hands of Hogan's very difficult.
Vandenberg to half forward. He's in front again, Davis. He got pushed out of that brilliantly by Hogan.
He is just asserting himself physically, isn't he? We saw him do it a bit last week, but now he's doing it on Phil Davis. He gave Stephen May a lesson last week.
So Jesse Hogan.
And fancies his chances
he
here.
He does. Gee, for a Melbourne fan, this is just so exciting. He used his body at the right moment. Collected the mark. Goes back. And then scrubs the kick to the top of the square. Amumbo was trying to sneak in, but Haynes with the acrobatic mark and dive. Comes away. Kicks to McCarthy.
This is the problem.
Yeah. Every kick's to a contest, sure.
And they've got numbers. You can see them. Like, they've just really hemmed them in now. This is really good defensive play. A bit like Sydney Swans under Paul Ruse. Exactly how he liked to set up.
There's the chip kick.
That's a set play.
Wasn't a good one, though.
No, it wasn't.
He kicked it to Garlett with two players on him and Mumford not far away.
Well, he probably thought someone had to jump over the top then.
You've got to give him time to get there.
Yeah, true.
Canelio had McCarthy in mind again, but once more, they're outnumbered.
Playing a game, Tom McDonald.
He worked it over to Salem. Scrubby one.
Now they've got no one to kick to and got to go over the top, and there's a loose man.
They needed a good bounce there, and it wasn't likely. Watts, they work well with Jetter and Salem. He's got McDonald for the short. Well done by Shield. But the siren sounds to end. An outstanding quarter for Melbourne, but a dreadful one for the Giants. At home in Canberra, they have failed to score a goal in the opening term. It's Melbourne 4-2-26, leading the GWS Giants just two behinds. We're back shortly to Canberra. Melbourne, everything going right for them, and they deserve it. They've made all the running here in Canberra at Star Track Oval. They've kicked the only four goals of the opening term. Mark Jamar getting in on the act, and you're going nicely when the ruckman's able to grab it out of the ruck and pop it through. Fairly lacklustre opening term from the Giants, as you can see on the board. It's 4-2-26 Melbourne, and just the two behinds to the GWS Giants. Shortly we're going to hear from Paul Ruse. In the meantime, Jason Dunstall and Tony Shaw have cast their eye over this opening term.
Can't speak highly enough about the way Melbourne started this game. More committed, more desperate. Contested possession shows up 38-28 in favour of the D's. They've made GWS look pedestrian. They've been really, really good. They've smashed them at the stoppages. The clearances are 13-6. And at the moment, sure, it looks to me as one team desperately wants it and the other doesn't quite want it badly enough.
I nearly agree with that in a lot of ways. And the other thing is this, and that term structure, but you look at this Melbourne team, they look very similar to how Sydney Swans played under Ruse, that you hem the side in, you keep pressure on in your forward line, you've got a number of targets, and then behind play, they've got a wall sitting there. I thought McDonald was fantastic, Dunn was good. They've just got total control in the back half.
Down to Moons.
Thanks, guys. Roosie, fantastic start. I thought Mark Jamar really set a tone for you there.
Yeah, he did. He's got his hands on the ball. That's going to be a key battle. Their midfield's really good. Mumford's a great player as well.
What about defensively? Just set up brilliantly. Just didn't allow them to get any of their running game going.
Yeah, they sort of tried to get us up and turn us around. So you just got to watch that. They've got a lot of good, you know, good hard running players.
Thanks, Roosie. Good for your time, mate.
Thank you, Roosie. And thank you to Moons downstairs. 24 points is the margin. What do you think Leon Cameron, other than a general lift all across the board, would have been saying to his players there?
Well, I first and foremost would have given them a blast about their attitude, because to me it doesn't look switched on. It doesn't look like they're desperate enough. They just think it's going to happen, because they have got a lot of skillful, pretty players, but you can't wait for it to happen. You've got to make it happen.
Let's see if there's any sort of turnaround at the start of this second term. Melbourne 4-2. Giants just the two behinds. Again, it's Jamar and Mumford who start in the middle. And again, Jamar, his follow-up work outstanding. Shaw kept busy with Kent. Got through to Davis and Dawes. There's worries everywhere for the Giants. Watts is turned.
Great tackle.
And that's a statement made by Joel Patful.
And see, that's the beauty of Joel Patful, because Watts actually turned him and had him beaten. But Patful had the speed and the agility to turn, pick up the couple of metres space, and then lay a terrific tackle.
Here's an excellent pickup for the Giants. Short to Cornelio. He's something they didn't have, isn't he,
yeah.
Patful?
Can play tall, small. Good athlete. Plenty of experience.
You know what Melbourne have done? They've done exactly this. They have slow played GWS. Yeah. GWS love to hit the corridor and run the lines. They have just really done a great defensive job behind play here, Melbourne.
Whereas Melbourne, when they get it, they go quick and they've always got loose players working into space.
Now he's going to have to kick down the line here unless he goes real short.
Adam Treloar with only two disposals too for the Giants. It's another one of their star playmakers.
Yeah, that was a better contest. Jeremy Cameron really hit the pack hard. That's what you want to see him doing.
Ryan Griffin has had seven disposals, but as we saw, not a big effect on this game. He's laying tackles there though, strongly and earning a free kick.
Oh, he's got to do that. He's got to get involved. He's kicking at 33% at the moment, so he's the seven turn really in the two effective ones, Hutto, but he has picked up since the last 10 minutes of that first quarter.
Sure.
Look how slow they are. Look.
Scully making the running out wide. Accepted the pass from Shaw. Shaw's up to 11 disposals now. Leads all comers on the ground.
That's the bonus of being a one-team player for your whole career, Josh. Just don't get those boos when you go.
Got a blood rule. Jetta coming off with the blood. Bernie Vince will replace him.
He's another good story, I think, Neville Jetta, for Paul Ruse. I thought he was going nowhere in his career, but he's even last year he played really well as a small defender, so he's turned him around, got him playing really consistent football. He's a talent.
Margin 24. Early stages of this second term. Mumford got the timing right. Ward and Cornelio eventually sorted out who was going for it and who wasn't. Howe went to ground. Lumumba stripped of it. Salem was encircled by Giants players, and it was Shield that was able to get it out. The kick in again is an error from Palmer. Dunn's got Melbourne moving again. Bernie Vince. Handicap of a metre or two is too much for Patful to close.
Really good work rate from Watts in it, Jay. He's made sure he's presented, given that out. Now, last year, he wouldn't have done that, Watts.
Yeah. No, he's working a lot harder, isn't he?
Cross to Dunn, and now they're away again. The sun may be a factor there for Howe. Brings it back in for Lumumba. Kent, an uncomfortable moment or two, knowing that Shaw was coming.
He might have been able to get there to spoil in time, but at least he held play up. On that occasion, Heath Shaw.
Dean Kent.
Jamar's got Griffin in the goal, down near the goal square at the minute.
It's a low ball. Vandenberg was one target. Jamar the other. It goes the way of Aaron Vandenberg. Hogan's going to come late. And with conviction, he's been paid.
It hit the ground. You can hear Ryan Griffin. He clearly said it hit the ground.
It was a bit of a scream too, wasn't it?
This is the bonus of being such a big-bodied young man. When he hits bodies in the air, he doesn't get knocked off the ball at all, Jace, does he? He just keeps his body nice and strong, and that's why he's been able to take these big contested marks so far.
Just looks mature, very, very early in his career. Looks like he mixed it with the big boys.
He's kicked one, he missed another long shot. And what about that for Jesse Hogan? That's a double.
Who's turning into a horror day for the Giants if they don't get something going at the moment? But if you're a D's fan, enjoy it. They did it last week. They've picked up where they left off. In fact, they're probably playing even better. This has been comprehensive. Let's have a look at the mark. He comes third man up. Does the ball hit the deck?
Oh.
Tell you what, it looks risky from that angle. I'd like to see it from another angle.
You'll probably see it from here. Oh, yeah, I reckon
that
did.
He dragged it along the ground and then held it up like a good forward does. Half his luck.
Too smart.
Well, it's a terrific goal. The mark was questionable, but Melbourne now lead by 30 points. What a difference Jesse Hogan's going to make to Melbourne's forward line this year. We've seen enough evidence already. Lumumba tried to wade through the pack, couldn't. Griffin put his head down. Green, Shield gets a bit of a go at it now. Dylan Shield inside 50. They need a goal. This has to go through, and it does. And it comes from the boot of Dylan Shield, 5 minutes into the second term.
Well, they just needed a clearance. They needed to win a clearance, didn't they? 15-8 at the moment. They got a few handballs over the top, and Dylan Shield kept the ball alive inside 50. Normally a left, a beautiful left-foot kick. Normally has had a couple of turnovers today, but to balance shows he's got a lot of poise. He knows what's around him. Now he's not under pressure.
It's rare to see left-footers kick on the right peg, sure.
Well, that's, well, I kicked once and he rocked my whole career. That is a great finish for a left-footer.
It's a mighty good effort off his right boot, Dylan Shield.
They needed it, though, didn't they? Just to get a bit of emotion into the game.
Maybe that's the start of something for them. Jones, Treloar, who's been extremely quiet. Shield again comes out, giving them something up forward. Green decided to take on Garland and was rewarded for his bravery or boldness, at the very least. Toby Green wants to lay it off. You can see that. We know kicking is not his strong suit.
Yeah, doubt he's got the journey, but you can still kick it to the advantage of a teammate here. They need to capitalise on this possession. Plenty of space in the pocket.
When you kick, you don't kick it long. You want to really kick a helicopter because they travel a bit further, but he's just set it up there.
Cameron didn't get the run that he would have liked. McDonald did.
Yeah, see, if I'm Jeremy Cameron, I'm dirty because I've made three leads, and in the end, all he's done is kick it to the space where my man can get there first.
Well, I don't think it had enough height on the kick anyway. Yeah, put some pressure on the defensive side to say, I'm going to sit under it.
Watts put himself under pressure there, forced to kick off the left, and it's farmed away, but Cross getting to the right places at the moment for the Demons. It was a miss from Dawes, but no dramas. Vandenberg sweeps in, gives it to Bernie Vincent. Garlett had Buck running one way. He was meantime going the other.
Yeah, well, Tommy Buck, he was under enormous pressure there because they were just so, had so much space in the middle of the ground then, and Bernie Vince finished off beautifully.
Not much you can do as a defender. Chasing Garlett because he's sprinting back towards goal, and then he stops props and leads up. Good luck trying to stick with him.
So Jeff Garlett, such an influential player last week. Sadly for Melbourne fans, leaves this one well to the left.
Yeah, he doesn't always convert the way he should. I know he creates lots of opportunities.
2 goals, 4 last week. He's off in the same fashion today. It's his first scoring shot, which as you saw was a minor. Melbourne's lead, though, is 25 at the moment. Shaw into Green. Decides to take them on.
Thomas Bugg's gone down.
Oh, he's gone out.
Tommy Bugg's down.
He's gone down behind
plate. I'm not sure who's whacked him, but he's
Ed Scarlett. There's a couple of players have gone over to remonstrate with him. He was down, taking some big ones. I don't think it was anything serious. It might have just copped him in a low position. Let's have a look. Oh, just a little bump. That's nothing wrong with that.
Just taking Tommy the Bugg wind out of him there, I think.
Yeah.
Tommy Bugg knows about those little bumps.
That was slightly different to last week's one. But it's a good point, Shorey. Haynes tries to take it away from there, but it's not coming out easily. Treloar's got some issues. He knows it. And he did well to get to his feet then, Treloar, because he may well have been cooked. You heard the umpire's voice there. Just fell under him. Look at all the numbers around the ball. No space to work in at all. Mumford fends it away. Nervous times for the Giants. Kelly's kick takes him into the back pocket. Green, you can see his intent was just to take it over the line. Didn't hide it all that much, and he got his wish. Patch-up job completed on Neville Jetta. He's ready to return to the fray very shortly. Dawes, Green, Bernie Vince. Bouncing ball to half forward, towards full forward. And it's over again.
Normally you look to Jeff Garlett to be a target here, running towards goal on a set play here. Dawes is in the ruck, so maybe not the dominant ruckman doing this tap.
Mumford drags
There's
it down.
Garlett.
He snatched it away, Garlett. And what a brilliant strike from Jeff Garlett from the pocket.
Well, this is a miracle snap. You can have 100 goes at that, and you'll probably kick it three or four times. It's a sensational snap. He loses Bug through traffic, and you'll see Bug drop off. But that is just an amazing snap. He gets a nice bounce.
Oh.
Just eludes the padding around the post. But that's a sensational snap.
Well, I thought he might be dangerous, but that was a handball intercept. Just you wouldn't kick one out of 100 hit like that.
Oh, the Demons lead by 31 points here in Canberra now. Jeff Garlett kicks his first. And that's one to remember. Back in the middle again. Mumford trying to generate something out of the heart of Star Trek Oval. Green. They work pretty well in confined spaces.
How is that not 15?
I think it was touched off the boot.
Sounded like he said not 15.
Yeah, I think he did say not 15.
It was a 20-metre kick.
I think because it went over his head, he couldn't really play the mark after he said it.
Definitive thump forward there from Bernie Vince. Brilliantly trapped by Vandenberg. He goes again, does Vandenberg. On the half volley for Dawes. Tries to just get past with strength. He did enough to Viney, and suddenly they're in dangerous territory again. Watts has it knocked away by Patful. Tyson there to pounce. Got it in the pocket. Hemmed in well by Shaw. And then finally Shaw rewarded for his persistence and tackling. And now Haynes can take the Giants out to the wing. Hard work up the ground from Jeremy Cameron.
Good kick from Haynes too. He had no other option.
Can they come to life here, the Giants? Melbourne are all over them.
They've got to look the switch because there's no... It's got to be... Oh, lovely kick in the centre. That's the switch you need to open him up, but he's a left footer, Shields.
Got to go quick.
Goes onto that left boot, and that's a good, strong kick for Mumford. Who's marked it? Does he give it? Does he lay it off? Does he go back and have a shot?
Yeah, I'll take it on.
Slow down, go back and have the set shot. He had one kicked on him by Jamar in the first term. He gets a chance to get one back here.
Shane Mumford. Giants just one goal, kicked by Dylan Scheel in this quarter. Melbourne's lead is at 31, and that's only going to cut it by one behind.
I would think that's the first time the GWS hit someone in the corridor trying to switch the play to open up play. They've got to do that a lot more, even if they come backwards sometimes, to open up the other side of the ground.
Melbourne have only had one more inside 50.
Plus, it was their first mark inside 52, Shorey. So what it does, just opens the game up and allows you to get that ball inside 50 so much easier.
Hogan and Vandenberg both in the air. Shaw does his work on the ground. Again, they can come from every angle. Trelaw! Oh,
great courage.
He knew they were coming from everywhere, and his kick was very well. It was pretty well weighted. McCarthy
ran under
got
it.
The butterfingers today. He's dropped a couple. And the kick goes out to the back pocket. Viney and the Demons away. Both times, young McCarthy, and he's very young, so you've got to give him some latitude. Both times it's been 15 to 20 metres out from goal too. So it's cost them genuine opportunities to kick goals. Maybe the urgency levels have lifted just a fraction here. McCarthy went and got it and gets them that little bit closer to the big sticks.
I think you called that right, Hutto. There's no doubt they're running harder at the ball, GWS. They've just got to get a couple of goals in a row to score, to pull this this lead back and reward for some of that effort.
39 plays 9. It's been all Melbourne. You just sense that maybe the Giants have lifted a fraction. Scully, can they get some reward for that effort? Not on this kick. turning. Vince takes the mark. The umpire's whistle started to falter a bit there too. Kick goes out wide, well read through the air by Lockie Whitfield.
Good to see.
Yeah, it was good to see last week as a number one draft pick starting to really get amongst it. He had 31 disposals.
Saw a shot on the bench for GWS of Nathan Wilson warming up. So maybe there's going to be a substitute activated for the Giants.
Any idea? Has anyone been struggling down there, Moons?
Look, I will say Tomlinson was the one at a quarter time that was in the hands of the trainers. He had, did get his legs strapped as well. So that's he's 50. The one for me that looks like he might be in a bit of trouble.
Lucky not to get 50 there because he threw the ball away.
That's a bit of a structural one, Moons, if it is Tomlinson too, isn't it?
Well, he's the guy that goes into the ruck, isn't he? So they're going to have to find someone else for that role.
Well, he's out there now, so he's
not moving. Well, that's
no, he's not.
Yeah, well, like I said, he was in the hands of the trainers at quarter time, jumping off that left leg, and yeah. He really struggled to do it. And just seeing there, that he's really big hobble. Yeah. So I dare say he's the man, guys.
Good stuff, Moons. 6-3-39 Melbourne. 1-3-9 GWS Giants. Mumford knocked it away. This is Newton. Captured, though, in the tackle. Green, he's trying to lift them. Cornelio pokes a ball through to Treloar. Their bigger names are starting to get a feel for the footy. Inside for Kelly.
Yeah, that's a good kick.
Yeah, he can kick the distance, this bloke. He'll take it on. I reckon he's got one of the best disposals of the ball for a youngster coming into the game.
And no coincidence, Shorey, then. They got the ball forward and found a table because they moved it quickly. You don't give Melbourne a chance to get their numbers back and set up the defensive.
Tomlinson just running off now, guys. And so this will be the sub will be made.
Yep. So Josh Kelly comes in.
Every time you give someone a rap, they normally let you down.
Yeah, well, the distance wasn't a problem.
Now Ford misses at the moment.
They've had a few, as you can see. 1-4 the Giants. And Melbourne 6-3-39. And there is Tomlinson putting on the red vest.
Oh, he took him on.
McDonald just gets out of jail. Jams it on the boot. It's all GWS there. Davis crossed to Ward. He can thump it back in again. Have a bit of a run from the side. McCarthy couldn't drag it down. Well, Palmer got crunched.
Good attack on the footy there from Cam McCarthy. He's getting his hands to a few. He's just got to make them stick. At least he's always attacking the footy. You've got to love that about him.
Mumford. Body's going everywhere there. Palmer copped it. Cameron, the last to get up, hand it over.
Most sides here go to the boundary because that's the space. The space is there. You can run onto it. Melbourne hit it back in the corridor, which is dangerous.
Mumford.
In the back.
Fell into his back.
Right. He had a set shot earlier this quarter. He's got to kick this one. Almost directly in front. You're 40, 35 metres out. It's just a must-kick goal for the Giants. And he is one bloke out there that can pick him up and get him going. If he starts to bowl a few over, get some ball going forward, kick a goal, take a mark or two, he'll drag him along with him.
In the round four clash last year, he had 60 hit-outs. Not going to be the case today. He goes back, though. It's all about the shot for goal.
Oh, that's
a cheap shot, Jamar.
Gee, he was lucky not to give another free kick away then.
Mummy wants to have a chat to him too.
Big dinosaurs too, boys. They've been giving it to each other all day. Jamar's been unbelievably strong in the contest with him. No doubt Mummy will be a little bit fired up now, want to come back.
Yeah, I don't mind him being strong, but I tell you, he could have given a free kick away then.
Salem looks for Watts.
Yeah, they Frost. Got a three-on-one there, Melbourne. Where is the GWS mindset at to allow that?
Next step for Frost is just a short one. Down the line for Garland. Margin still 28. Blowing some chances in this quarter, the Giants. Got to go by hand now. Lumumba, we know he loves to run and kick it as much as he can. Haynes in good spot to mark, but Hogan fought the fight all the way to the end. Haynes, untidy handball. It was an express one right at the feet of Wilson, who's the sub who's on the ground. Nathan Jones decides to keep it bubbling. Tyson stripped of it. Coming back the other way, Cornelio, Shield. Weaving his way through, made some headway, kicked it up to the wing, and it's still just in. Fine line. Howe swooping back through McDonald. Now Salem. Again, loath to kick it because there's nothing on for them. Salem decides to chance the arm.
That's too easy.
Vandenberg with the spillage. Lumumba never going to have any room to move. Careful play by Scully, which was needed under the circumstances. Vince gets his kick away. So they're inside 50. It remains a scrappy affair there. Over the boundary line and out of bounds. So I don't think that'll worry the Demons at all at the moment. Giants have been unable to make any real headway, certainly on the scoreboard. 6-3, plays 1-5. Still 28 points the difference. JMO got the tap. Shield gets the run of it.
Fumble.
But it was a critical fumble, or it could have been. Kent, now Buck's gone to ground. Have another ball up. Again, JMO, this time got a little shove from Mumford. Shield. Some relief at the back of the pack. Whitfield. And now Patful. Just took an extra step to try and balance himself and hope that he had a good option. It was a one-on-one with Cameron and McDonald. And Devin Smith.
Want to go out of bounds.
McFly was on his side there. You can hear the protest from the Melbourne fans. Smith just had two disposals so far. Doing it all there. Still 6.5 minutes remaining. Some work being done on Reece Palmer, so
can't afford another one.
No, they certainly can't. Too high on Toby Green. Works it back to Heath Shaw. His 13th disposal brings Lockie Whitfield back into the game again. That's a good looking kick. For Griffin, finally, they've got a little bit of run here and overlap. Scully takes them inside. This has to count. It has to count, and he's missed as well. And that will bring enormous joy to the Melbourne fans.
Well, they've kicked 1-6. I mean, it's 7 scoring shots to 9, and yet you still find yourself 27 points down. They're kicking themselves away from any hope they had of getting into the contest at the moment.
6-3 to 1-6. This quarter, the Giants have kicked 1-4. Melbourne have managed 2-1. So in terms of scoring shots,
that's 1-4 from 10 inside 50s.
Yep.
And they've only had 5 inside 50s, the D for 2 goals. So talk about efficiency and better use of the football.
Their kicking efficiency in this quarter, the Giants is 59%.
And Melbourne up at 70.
JMO's removed Mumford this time. Free kick to the big number 41. Sorry, Shuri.
I think there's been a change in the trend of the game, though. I think they're going all right, GWS.
Yeah,
but
it's
they
just
need
not
to
on the scoreboard.
Yeah, exactly.
They bunch on. McCarthy was up. Cameron tried to break the tackle. Gang tackle it was.
McCarthy is so close, Jason.
Oh, isn't he? Moves.
Apart, isn't he?
You know what? Still rough and raw, but a bloke that attacks the contest like that, he's going to have success eventually.
What you love from Melbourne, as soon as the ball hits the ground, it's the second, it's the third and fourth number that they get to the contest. They're completely outnumbering GWS around the ball at the moment.
The contested possession count this quarter is still even.
And this is where I find GWS really disappointing from a defensive perspective. Instead of pressing up and stopping Melbourne finding easy targets, they just don't work as hard as the Melbourne players do to create space.
You know what it is, Jason? I think they stay with their own man and they just don't acknowledge that you can leave your man to zone and make a harder kick for the opposition.
Yeah, you guard the dangerous man.
Ugh.
Tyson went searching for Hogan again. Kent tries to bust a move through there.
Great tackle. He just trapped one of the arms in the tackle. Thought that he got a handball to him.
Bugs Footy back onto the wing. Ward, and again, it was a slow play when it didn't necessarily have to be. Pokes the kick, and look, Shield's done well enough to get there and take the mark.
Swinging board, yeah, left
better.
Footer.
That's better now. More an automatic, instinctive move from the Giants. Plenty on the kick. Jeremy Cameron's in front. McDonald had the prime position, though. He knew where the ball was going to drop. Cameron fought the fight for as long as he could, and at least it's deep in their attacking area. Well done to the Melbourne defence, though. They've been able to withstand a fair bit in this quarter. But, boy, they've been helped by the inaccurate kicking from the Giants. 27 points remains. What is a pretty big gap between these two sides. Frost got the tap down.
Now, sometimes Jeremy Cameron, we really worry about the defensive side of his game and his second efforts, but I reckon about three or four times in this quarter, he's had a three-on-one.
Yep.
You know, he's at least tried to bring the ball to ground.
Jetta gets his wish over the boundary line. A couple of appeals for deliberate.
On the lead up, Cam.
Go unheeded. There's that battle again. You still fancy it's going to be very important in the outcome of this game. McDonald, very accomplished defender. Jeremy Cameron, one of the rising star forwards. Oh. How about that for improvisation? Frost got it out of there, but it's coming back through core. Done. And Palmer had to turn defender there.
Yeah, well done, Palmer. It would have been an uncontested mark to Dunn otherwise. Nothing wrong with the little bloke playing the defensive role, jumping over the top, punching it out of bounds. They get a stoppage, they get to reset.
Too many players around this contest for GWS. You've got to get dangerous, but find space. Look at that. Too easy to get that out.
Frost hammers it out of there to the wing, but again, it's going to come back. Phil Davis is given a half metre. Turn it into five, kicked it forward. Jones in front, Frost the spoil. Up for grabs, Lumumba waded back through. Frost off the boot, could go anywhere. Towards the wing, it was a well-placed ball in the end. Ward was decided that he would take
good
on Watts.
Tackle.
And he kept spinning and got turned over the line. And the Melbourne players go to Jack Watts. They love the effort, the enthusiasm.
It's good effort on both fronts, wasn't
it?
Callum Ward worked hard. He took front spot. He got there first and attacked the footy. Then it was a really good tackle from Jack Watts.
Ball back into play again. Jones. Handball almost to the line. Newton. Here's Vandenberg. Tried to shape the handball. In the end, probably all the players happy enough for that to go over and out.
I reckon we're seeing the impact of Tomlinson not being able to go on the ruck already, boys. Trying to pick up who's in it now.
McCarthy's the one,
well, he's a non-ruckman, really. Yep. He wouldn't know. And he's been outnumbered a couple of times in the clearances. Yeah.
He's dwarfed here, isn't he, relatively?
Yeah.
He'll have a crack
by Jamar, who gets it down. So the Giants midfielders have to be alert, don't they? They have to be, know that they're not going to more than likely get first use from their ruckman.
But the other thing, too, with McCarthy, he goes forward. He's going to be gone, boys. He's got his hands on his knees right there now. He's feeling the pinch. He's going to have to go forward and try and be a marking target for it. It's hard to do both.
Holding Melbourne.
And there it is.
There's
right
a free
there,
kick
sorry.
Right there.
Jamar got to dictate terms. Wins the free.
He's got to get away from the contest, McCarthy, and just try and get a run and jump at it instead of body on body.
Shaw is the extra back, but he didn't get in front of Chris Dawes where the kick was aimed at. Well played. Haynes successfully takes it over the line and out of bounds. And when McCarthy's coming off, Mumford's coming back on. So this will be a more even battle, although he's actually a bit lucky here, Shane Mumford. The boundary umpire took an extra second or two to wipe the sweat from his hands. Throws it back on. Mumford got manhandled. Should have got a free kick. Umpire didn't see it.
Look at Ward.
Well done. Well, he didn't get one either. Jetta crunching in hard now. Tyson found a bit of a path through. Garlett left it behind, but when he found it, Jones was in the right spot. Newton's closing in. He's got a powerful long left boot, and it's an accurate one. Oh, that stings. That really hurts.
And that's exactly what happens when you're wasteful at one end. It only takes a half an opportunity at the other. They hadn't been forward for a long time, the D's, and they... Look, gee, that courage from Callum Ward. He nearly should have got a free kick there for high contact, I would have thought. But then, this is just all about finishing. It's the quality of using the football in the attacking area. And Ben Newton's proven very effective in that respect. He was a goal kicker last week. He's done it again today.
He was only narrowly through for a goal, wasn't it? But a beautiful kick.
Well, crunch time here. Another goal, and you find it very hard that GWS could, you know, turn it around. Just got to hang in here for this two-minute period of the half-time and then get together and see if they can find something after that.
Cornelio hunting. Finds Buck back through the middle. Whitfield can run and use the left boot. And it's a well-placed ball for Kelly. Just a fraction too far out to score a goal, though, you'd think.
Spacing the forward line, just not many good leads coming.
McCarthy makes it gets to the spot. This time, he hugs in the ground.
He doubled Garland twice there, boys. It was a double lead, Jace. Exactly what key forwards need to work like that.
We love this bloke because of his work rate, Shorey. And he's just had a stint in the ruck as well, so he must have a good tank. But I also love the kick. I love the fact that Kelly just waited and waited and waited and then just hit the space.
You can just see the work rate there of McCarthy. Works Garland over. Kelly just waited for him. Perfect play.
Critical kick. McCarthy comes in, follows up his good, strong work with a confident shot for goal. We're back to 27, and that's enough just to tease that they could still get back into this contest.
They should, there's no doubt they should be closer, Shorey.
Yeah. I think they've done a really good job. And as you said, their work rate, first quarter was insipid, their work rate. Now they have lifted. As you said, they haven't converted as well as you'd like. But no, they're in this game. They are in this game. And just well done to McCarthy. I thought he might take a long time to get over that little stint in the ruck. He came to the bench and, yeah, love the way he goes about it.
Be annoying for Paul Roos, so close to half time. Well played. And McCarthy, centre bounce. 50 important seconds remaining in the term. Shield just not taking any chances. Try to hack it forward. It's gone right out to the wing. Now the runners can do their thing. Green. Caught one high. It was a bit of a late call from the umpire.
They got time for another score here.
He gets a lot of high tackles, doesn't he, Toby Green? He just drops at the knees really smartly.
Jack Watts back loose. Got to keep it away from him.
Well, he didn't really, though. Took a bit off the kick. Still all Melbourne in the air. And Tom McDonald. Might just about kill it as far as the Giants are concerned in this quarter. Viney with the mark. Margin is 27. So Melbourne look like they're going to win this quarter, despite the fact they've had 10 less inside 50s for the term. It's a shove on Davis. He's not going to have time to do anything with it, sadly, for the Giants.
Just a touch too far out, although he wants to go back and practice his torpedoes, I think. No, he thought I might serious, do a quad. He thought about it.
So there'll be some enthusiasm about their effort in the second term, but the result of it, unfortunately, was nowhere near enough. If you're a Giants fan, they kicked 2 goals, 4 from 16 inside 50s. Melbourne only went inside 6 times in the quarter, and they produced 3 goals, 1 as we get down to Cameron Mooney.
Peter, not a fantastic start from you guys. It was really poor work rate, but finally started to get back into that game late in that quarter.
Yeah, no, it was a pretty average start, to be honest. I think we're getting a hand on the ball, panicking a bit. Inside 50, kicks have been really poor, just kicking it straight to their number. So something to work on for the second half, but that last sort of 10 minutes is pretty good.
What about going inside 50? You talked about that, but the goal kicking itself, you're just letting yourself down in front of goal, really could have got yourself right back into that game.
Yeah, there was a lot of effort to get it down there, and we're just not holding it in or getting that reward that we want. So big second half ahead, but we just got to grind it out.
Thanks for your time, mate. Good on you, mate. Good stuff. Sandy, back to you, my friend.
Good on you, Moons. Thank you very much for that. The margin is 20.
We'll be looking to be much straighter in front of goal, amongst other things, as we start this third term. It's 16 inside 50s to 6 for that quarter. They levelled up the clearances, though, so they're getting better in that area. They took the ball out of the middle 4 times to 1 from the centre clearances.
As good as they've been, the D's, I'm not prepared to write GWS off yet. Hello.
All right, well, these first few minutes, the intent of both sides will be interesting to observe. Third quarter then. Action underway. Jones, Ward, Treloar, and Viney makes 4. Footy not going anywhere out of there. Mumford, straight to Garlett. Next handball will cause nothing but trouble for Newton. Jetta. They're up to 50 again. Davis, prominent fist.
He's in some trouble, Newton, behind play, guys. That tackle, he's hit his head on the ground.
Oh, Shields' handball was dodgy. Thanks, Moons. Davis in all sorts of trouble with 4 demons around him. No getting out of there alive. Newton, meantime, getting to his feet at the very least. Had some concerns with some tackles in the opening round, so back at that one as well. Kelly back to the wing. That one sneaking through the fingers of Jeremy Howe. He's been pretty quiet today, Jeremy Howe. 6 disposals. Newton coming from the ground. On his own steam, at least. Jetta, Griffin, the cold face. Canelio's been good after being a sub in round 1. He's not much on the kick, unfortunately for him. Green sensed the problems. Shield Canelio charging through, trying to kick it off the ground. Eventually, scrambly play ends in a boundary throw.
A messy start for the first term, hasn't it?
That sling tackle is so hard to adjudicate because the tackler believes, or probably most times thinks, that the player's still got the ball.
Yep.
You've got to give him probably the benefit of doubt, I think, to tackle a lot of times on those occasions.
JMR, delicate tap down to Tyson. He's soon feeling it from
not
Muffin.
Making effort.
Has he done enough? Well, the ball squeezes out at the critical moment. There's a big tackle from Canelio. Oh.
Well, that's a good sign. A couple of really good tackles there from the Giants. They get the turnover.
Quick to lay it off. Griffin's got plenty on the kick. To the square. Wrestle was on. McDonald fended it away. Good follow-up from Vince. Shield careful not to give it away. Howe did as good as he could in the circumstances. Gets it to the line and over.
Gio, don't let that handball around the back for Griffin then, because if the kicker kicks a ball, Griffin can push in as a crumbing player or a player who wants to even push a person down the ground to go and crumb. But you're one man down. His opponent's probably run 20 metres to help fill a spot inside 50. It's just a cheap stat to get your stats up in numbers.
J-Mark got it down, but not out of trouble. Or Mumford has come up with all sorts of wondrous kicks in front of goal today.
He missed two relatively simple set shots in the second term, and now a shank to start the third. He could be having a big day.
Mm. I like their intensity, though. Yes. I think they've started well this third quarter. Tackling, they look intense at the contest.
Viney watching Ward closely as this one's thrown in.
Look at the space near the bigger bird. There's that spot there.
Treloar, his shield. Back to Treloar. Onto the left. Can he nail it? Oh, I like the angle of the kick. He shaped it beautifully. And they get the first in this third term. And it comes from the left boot of Adam Treloar. They haven't had it all their own way, those midfielders today. They have to really work themselves into the game. And it's a terrific result for the Giants.
Now, look at the space, which is boundary side. That should be your spot where you want to hit the ball. Now, the ball did go forward into that space. He allowed to run away from goal and straighten up on his left foot. But that's the space when you've got a ruckman to try and hit into there. Someone running towards goal or even just being able to snap around the shoulder like that.
Fine goal off the left. Adam Treloar.
A really good sign to see three Giants front and square that contest.
So they've continued with that energy from late in the second term. Again, they go forward through Treloar. Salem casting the role of true defender there. One-on-one was good. Took the mark and now has Hogan away, and they're charging forward. Instruction is to get it to Garland next, but he's got to contend with Shaw. It was just telegraphed a bit too much. And now they can go, the Giants. Sweeping handball from Scully. Not perfect, but it's okay. Haynes thumps it up towards the 50. Palmer's got to jump up here, which he does. Contended well with Dunn, and it's out of bounds.
Geez, Heath Shaw was good. Yeah. He left his man. Otherwise, Garland had run into space, would have had an easy possession, would have played on, but Shaw sprinted about 30 away from his man to create the spoil.
Demons have to be on guard here because the Giants look a different team to what we saw in the first quarter particularly. Mumford just given away. No, it's a freedom to Callum Ward. He's working his way into the game. His 11th disposal coming up. Trots around. Gives them all a bit of a run. It's dropped a bit short. McDonald was in the right spot again. Bypassed a number of players to get through to Howe. And now Bernie Vince. He hasn't had a big day, but his 9th disposal was right. Dom Tyson. Marks at half back, and he too gains another 20 metres. Once again, Jeremy Howe with an unlikely fumble. But he's given that kick plenty. It's very wide.
So the D's have made this up too, Hutto. And Angus Brayshaw's running around out there.
I think it's Ben Newton who's been subbed off. Watts in the squeeze. Top of the square.
Garlic dangerous.
Out-muscled that time. Ward plays his own footy along and just bundled across to Patful. There's Giants everywhere. A bit of uncertainty about it.
Oh, well done.
In the end, the handball was terrific. Created a good run for Shield. Now, this is what Scully can do. He can charge forward. He's got nothing to give. And finally, it's Nathan Wilson he entrusts the kick with. And the kick's going to go through. It looked unlikely. It looked uncertain. But it's on the board.
Gee, that is a great finish. And he's actually
come out, Nathan Wilson standing, Jeff Garland, he's pushed all the way forward. But it was really interesting watching Tom Scully running forward. He was desperate for Jeremy Cameron to turn around and lead up at him. But Cameron, you'll see at the bottom of the screen if he comes into shot, has got his back to the footy, just coming out of the left of the screen. He's got his back to the football all the way. He needed to turn around and hit up. You can see Scully's going, someone lead to me, someone lead to me. But that's a great finish for Wilson.
Time your leg, jump
to
the footy.
They've kicked the last three. Down to you, Moons.
We just spoke about the sub before, guys, with the Melbourne. Newton, look, he's just had the 20-minute concussion test at the moment, so it's only the 20-minute sub at the moment.
Okay.
Interesting.
All right, more on that in a moment. Lumumba did his best to get boot to ball. That's about all he achieved. Jamer, shut down, no free kick. But it does go the Giants' way, and haven't they lifted? Runs around in circles a bit there, Mumford. Got it safely, though. And now they can attack from this wing. Short kick out wide for Griffin. Took it. And it's a low ball, and it was right under the chest of McCarthy.
Not sure that was the target story, but you know what? This bloke plays in front, he attacks the footy. Love it. Love the chit. Now, we've got a game on our hands.
I'll give him credit. I'll say he meant that, but I don't think he did. Ryan Griffin. Lace out, though. Look, this has started from the contest. The clearances, they've started to run the lines. And some great tackling.
So Cam McCarthy already has a goal to his name. He was impressive last week with three goals. Just 20 years of age. And doesn't he give them something up forward? He's put that through. They are right back now. Back to 9 points.
Well, you called this, Jace. You called it. You thought there was still a sting in the tail here. And there's no doubt it came in that second quarter. When you've had 10 more inside 50s and haven't scored, that's the issue in the game. So we'll give you credit on that one, but I think even blind Freddie could have read it.
Well, what they have done, though, is they've rewarded themselves on the scoreboard. So we've got a terrific contest on our hands now. And now it's up to the Demons to respond.
Well, I think Paul Roos was most happy with last week as they were challenged several times by Gold Coast and they responded. Well, they're being challenged now. Four consecutive goals from the Giants. It's a 9-point ball game here in Canberra. Jamar poked it away. Callum Ward continues to show that desperation and intent. The race is on. They're coming from all angles. We know Cross is not quick, so he went hard at the teammates. Oh. The opposition. Treloar got crunched by Viney. They came in from all angles. It's hotting up. The crowd's getting involved. It's good stuff, Shorey.
Well, you've got to watch that. You've got to watch that, Jack Viney, because Treloar's got his head down over there, and he sort of nearly went with his head. And the umpie said he didn't hit him in that spot, so well done. Great attack on the ball.
Mumford taps it down. Scully, speculative handball. Here's Ward. Only knows one way. Straight ahead. And then he got himself in a position to kick a goal and just couldn't quite do it as it drifts. And they are a transformed team at the moment, this GWS Giants combination.
Looked good for a long time, that kick. There's the tackle. He plays it hard, Jack Viney.
They're in here.
They've snared it again in the pocket. Toby Green.
A short kick on 15 metres in front of Toby Green.
Yeah, he had a couple of options.
Had Kelly in particular 25 metres out from goal.
Well, no question they put the pressure on the older guys, I think the leaders of this group, at half-time, boys. We saw Shaw come off his opponent. You spoke about that, Jason. We've seen Cullen Ward, big tackle, big clearances, doing some big things this quarter.
Bernie Vincent again. They're putting the squeeze on, making it hard to get it out of there. And Melbourne are wilting just a little bit. Here's a replay. Green, this time he gave the responsibility to someone else. And that someone else was Canelio. And they're within one.
Well, haven't things changed very, very quickly? All of a sudden, it's just dominance from the Giants. They've kicked the first four of this third term. But if you have a look at the clearances, it's 9-2. They are smashing him around the stoppage. It's 41 possessions to 14 already in this third term. Seven inside 50s for six scores, four goals two. And Melbourne just can't get their hands on the footy. This has been outstanding.
Five unanswered goals, 4-2 to nothing in this quarter.
Where was this in the first half?
It is a different lineup, as I said, or it appears to be. Viney, again, misses the target. Whitfield sneaks in, got manhandled. Play on, Mumford. He's stripped off at Kelly. It's all one-way traffic. They're inside again. Charging out hard was Palmer. Lumumba, a cool head needed. He's kicked.
Covered with the hands.
Unfortunately, it wasn't paid him up.
No, he doesn't know he's there behind him.
Haynes sneaks it into the forward line, up to the 50. Onto the left, Treloar again. Skyscraper to full forward, a run and jump from Scully. Palmer, how done, good hands. Jetta, Melbourne had to be assured of the footy, and they were. Vandenberg eases the kick. Dawes, will he take the wind out of it? Can he hold up here? He's going to be tackled. And if they can maybe get it out of bounds, they can get their breath back.
Oh, well done to the two GWS boys there. Gee,
contact below the knee.
Yeah, well, he dived on it and then made contact with Chris Dawes' leg.
So it's a pretty open forward line at the moment for Melbourne if they can get it in there quickly. Jack Watts has got the forward 50 to himself. So I think a lot of players quite spent, taking a while to get down the ground. You can see there that there's no one beyond those group of players. You can see in the middle of your screen.
Pretty much one-on-one all over the ground.
Hogan kicks it very wide. Wasn't a lot for him. Out of bounds.
I'm quite surprised at Jack Watts. Normally, when they have goals kicked, like 2 to 3 in a row, Jack Watts goes and plays behind the ball.
Good hands here from Cornelia, wasn't it?
How good was that? Margin is one. Sprightly stuff, this from the Giants at the start of the third.
Tell you what, Mumford. He's trying to lift them there, Hutto.
Yeah, Jones, bit of a wayward handball. Intercept was on, and they've got mass exodus here for the Giants. Green, got it to Palmer. They can cut them up through the middle. Scully, a couple of bounces. Again, loath to kick it until something materialised for him in the pocket. Lockie Whitfield, hemmed in by Lumumba. So he hoiks it back in hope dangerous. More than anything. And suddenly it's opened up the corridor for the Ds. Howe shoved it out to Viney. And now Brayshaw into the action. Great awareness, stepped inside, gives Dawes a bit of a run, used his body, got to the front on Haynes, took it at ground level, runs straight into more Giants though, holding the ball, not paid. Kent the same treatment, the tackling's relentless from the Giants, under pressure now, Patful gets the run of the kitchen, close to the line, Jones will be determined to put a stop to this. Takes it over and out, we'll have a throw in.
Oh, gee, I don't know what Lockie Whitfield was trying to do, but that was a horrible kick. Deep in his forward 50, there's a good aggressive tackle. But we're seeing these tackles, that they are aggressive, but just hope that the head doesn't hit the deck when it happens.
Jamar and Mumford. Down to Shield. He squeezes a kick out of there and it pitches just inside the line.
Oh, I think Mumford's been brilliant in the start of this quarter. He looks like he's just taken it to Jamar and say, well, look, I've got to pick this side up. It might have an injury. The one coming to the boundary line now.
Haynes
limping.
Moons to follow that one up. Hall returning to the action. Bit of a standoff between the two ruckmen there. Other were left standing. Vandenberg got plenty on the kick. Oh, good body work, Hogan. He just couldn't get to where the ball dropped. We're baying for blood. The Melbourne fans hoping for holding the ball.
He didn't drag it in, the ball actually came out. Just having a look here.
Let it go. Let it go, guys. Fair bit of pain, Haynes. These signs not good on that one. Jamar into the dangerous path. Out of there from Cornelio, having a big, big match, really. McCarthy, manhandled by Garland. You heard the disdain from the umpire. Play on. Vandenberg gets it through to Jetta. They come again, the Ds. They're having a few cracks. Jack Watts! Oh, it was a great fly. Just couldn't drag it down. Two points the difference. It's Melbourne getting a little bit of the footy in the last couple of minutes.
Oh, it's a good test of their character now, isn't it? And dominating for so long in this game.
Careful kick in from Wilson to Shield.
He's really started to come into the game as well, getting plenty of it. He's coming up to possession number 17 now.
He's a smart player too.
Moons, any indication on what the story with Haynes is down there? Because having lost Tomlinson, they can't really afford to lose another big body.
He's getting a bit of work down here on both legs at the moment, but it's the right leg on the inside. He's getting some padding put on there at the moment, so I'd say he's got a little bit of a corky in there and he's trying to protect it.
Mumford McDonald had his eyes on that one but couldn't drag it down. Jeremy Cameron is a chance here. Trelaw runs into a brick wall of Fulani.
Well done.
Got it onto the boot somehow. Full commitment from both teams at the moment. Up for grabs. Palmer got Whitfield, got Scully. Couldn't get it to either of them. Good, strong defence required by the Demons, and they show it. They display it to all, and we'll have a ball up. This game has really come to life in the third term.
I'll tell you what, Lockie Whitfield, boys, he's as tough as a cat's head. Or as hard as a cat's head.
There's the throw up.
One of them.
To Devin Smith. Oh no!
You can't
miracle
keep that.
Miracle of miracles! Devin Smith, what a goal! And they are in front.
I'm not sure you can do that, Shorey.
I don't believe you can, but look, they're winning the contest, and I talked about Mumford, just the control and the ruck in this first 10 minutes of this quarter. But that there's that space. That's the space of, it's nearly like a set play, and it should be the area you go to, because if you come back in the corridor, there's players behind the ball. I reckon that is a set play, but you don't convert from there.
That is magnificent.
It was as hard as a cat's head anyway.
Oh, what a goal from Devin Smith, and what a quarter of football this is proving to be from the Giants.
Let it run!
5-2 to just one behind.
Twice as many possessions, twice as many inside 50s.
And they're going again. Cross comes in to try and close them down. Jones, tough one, that one. Jones takes it. And now Jack Watts has the responsibility. Tucked it under the arm and got plenty on the kick. Needs a big grab, can't get it. He's fighting on though. Hogan just couldn't get boot to ball in any significant fashion.
Phil, don't do it.
Toby Green marches away.
Oh, no. Oh, boy. That is a ridiculous free kick. And you're undisciplined when you're on total control, in total control of the game. You try to shepherd. You just let the man run past you. I'm trying to pick up who was the culprit on that occasion on
Nathan
the mark.
Core, is Nathan it? Core.
Well, Nathan Core, he just put his hand out. When you're trying to shepherd, you've got to make sure your arms are strong. You're on top of the game and you give a free kick like that against the flow. Don't do it, Phil.
Well, Dean Kent needs to. He needs to do it. He's got to kick straight here for Melbourne. Six unanswered goals, and that's not going to change that stat.
Yeah, Aiden Corby bringing the sigh of relief.
Haven't things turned around, though? Melbourne couldn't miss early, and it was a wasteful GWS. Now they're hitting the target. Melbourne getting a rare opportunity. Can't hit the target.
That's a critical bit of medical operation going on.
Whitfield's come on a long lead, but McCarthy's going to beat him to it.
Remembering that they've already lost Tomlinson through injury earlier on, so they'll be a man down if they can't get Haynes back, which is in this pretty torrid affair, could be quite telling later. McCarthy's kick, well, that was poorly done by the Demons. They had all the numbers, and neither player took the mark.
Let's just keep an eye on Haynes, who looks like he's going to be able to come back here. Oh, it's just a clash of the left knee on the leg of Dean Kent, so he just got a whack. That's good. It'd just be bruising.
Mumford, too hot for Shield. Oh, that was almost a free to Viney.
Look at Ward. Look at Ward.
Yeah. He just looks at the footy and nothing else.
Knows no fear.
No.
Kelly tried to get himself balanced. They've got much height there. Trelaw outsized, fought all the way through. Vince had some reserves at the back, but they were swamped straight away. He tries again with Viney. Shield just sweating on him. Got him! Well, got the handball away. And now it's out.
It's on behind play, boys.
It is Trelaw and Frost, is it?
Yep, old teammates.
Former teammates.
Frost gets it. What? Me?
No. Tell you what, you won't want to hit Adam Trelaw in the head.
Hard as a cat's head, is it, Joey?
Yeah, and tough as too.
Smith again got the ball doing plenty down there. McDonald and Cameron continue their tussle. Lumumba.
We'll take it out.
Ooh, he had to brace himself for contact there.
You can just see the intensity that's lifted down here, guys. The tackling pressure is incredible. Just their intensity around the ball, around the person. As soon as Melbourne get the ball, they're getting gang tackled at the moment. They're absolutely getting smashed.
28 more disposals this quarter, 6 more contested possessions. They've kicked 5 goals, 2 to 3 behinds. This term.
11 more clearances. That's the big one, though.
15-4. Use those numbers. So we're 7.5 to go. Time for more goals for the Giants, or of course for Melbourne to respond. Mumford, well restrained by Tyson. There's no getting out of there easily. Cornelio and Green have had the most disposals in the quarter. Cornelio with 8 and Green and Treloar with 7 each.
Yeah. Frost and Haynes starting to get a little bit antsy with each other off the ball as well. We just heard the umpire say, keep your eye on Frost. He was involved with Treloar moments ago.
Oh, amazing. I think Mumford's had a massive influence on this game in this third quarter.
Without any support, it'll be interesting to see.
Yeah, how he ties
all the way.
He's got a good tank. He can work hard, Mummy.
Bernie Vince becoming more prominent as the game continues. Chris Dawes is in his sights. Well done, Core. Did the disciplined, attentive thing. Got it to ground. It's all Melbourne there, though. Viney trying to keep it out of harm's way.
Terrific tackle.
Did well at the last minute to get a boot to ball, though. Salem got...
Good tackle again.
Lumumba into all sorts.
Where was this in the first half? Oh, mainly the first quarter, really. They did have a go in the second quarter, but couldn't convert from their inside 50s.
So well to get a boot on the ball, didn't he, Jack Viney?
High contact, GWS.
Yeah, Mummy wears one for the team there.
You know, the game's got very willing. I reckon the umpires have done a really good job with it. They've controlled it well.
Griffin to Shiel. Indulges in a bounce through the middle, which is courageous under the circumstances. Gets it back from Buck. He's every chance from here, Dylan Shiel. He's a beautiful kick of the football and shows it.
How good a play was that?
Oh, they are flying now.
He's a star, Dylan Shiel. I loved his game last week. I thought he was best on ground last week, and I'll tell you what, he's starting to have an impact here.
Take us through this, Jace. Well, how good was it?
What I loved was it looked like he was running into traffic, but he drew them in, hand passed over the top, and then found another gear to get the hand pass back. And you know what showed real class there? He broke open with his speed, but then he relaxed before he took the set shot. You have a look at the slow steps. He just slows down. There it is, and
that's
converts.
Class.
That is a glorious passage of play by Dylan Shiel.
Easy star.
And well done to McCarthy too, boys, because you see players try and mark those on the line and they fumble and it goes through in two goes. So he knew exactly what he was doing.
Clever from Green.
Especially because he dropped a couple earlier. <That's right. laughs>
See, Green won that clearance just by kicking it off the deck to the loose player out on the wing.
Here's McCarthy now.
He comes at it. Forced to ground. Shiel trying to have a rest in the pocket, no rest there. He did well to get involved again. Kelly swings around with Whitfield, pokes it into the pocket, and that's a good result for them because they were hopelessly outnumbered there.
See, they've got to get control of this, Melbourne. I don't know. They're trying to look to midfield to get a few more nuts. Maybe even Jeffy Garland up the ground a little bit to give you try and run the lines from the halfback line.
7 consecutive goals, 6 of them coming in this quarter for the Giants, and they're circling and looking for more here. We are getting a glimpse of what's to come with this Giants team, and that's unlucky.
He actually won the ball and then rolled over the back of the other player who'd missed the ball. That's a tough one. He's unlucky. You've got 2 players going at the ball. One wins the ball.
Yeah, well, he sits.
The other's missed it, but then he's sitting on his...
Got to pay it, but you're right, it is luck of the game. Wasn't it?
Well, kicked an extraordinary goal earlier in the quarter, Devin Smith. So that should be easy fodder for him. They've kicked 7 in this quarter. And that is 8 in a row, and they lead by 14 points.
7 goals, 2.
What a turnaround. Yep. What a turnaround. Yeah, look, you're right. It's our game. It's the game of footy, isn't it? It has to be a free kick, even though you're right, he had his hands on the ball. But you've got to try and avoid that contact, and that's what makes our game so great, not just the shape of the ball, but things that can happen like that in play. Gee, they need to stem. Who's behind play for Melbourne? We've got to look at that right now.
Margin is 14.
Still man on man, sure.
Yeah, no loose man. Just for 5 minutes, maybe, I would think. Just a runner who can get through the lines.
Mumford and Ward. This is classic stuff. Out of the middle. Well anticipated back there by Salem.
He's done a good job.
Yeah, it looks like just with a second pre-season under his belt, he's a much more assured player. But having said that, that was very nearly out on the full.
That was close.
Everyone wants to be a boundary umpire there.
Obie Green can't believe it wasn't paid.
No, that was right here in front of me, guys, and definitely a good, great kick, good mark.
Good on your Moons. Garland kicks to half forward, Haynes with the spoil. Down to Bark. Some uncertainty, but made the good decision. They've been using their hands brilliantly in this quarter. They've cut them open. Kelly puts it on a platter for McCarthy, who's growing and growing in confidence all the time.
I'll clear right now, Hutto. He's become the number one target for them. Jeremy Cameron hasn't got into the game today. He's struggled. McDonald's done a terrific job. But Cameron hasn't worked anywhere near as hard as this bloke in presenting. And if you don't get used, representing, finding a way to keep putting yourself in the vision, he deserves to kick a few goals the way he's worked, Cam McCarthy. Well, I think he's been terrific.
If the coach has set that up, that's what a coach wants. He wants his star to be selfless, to say, OK, some days it's not working for me. I want to be, you're going to be the decoy. Take two players with you. And if he set that up, well done, Leon Cameron.
So McCarthy for his second goal of the quarter. This for nine in a row for the Giants, and he kicks it with conviction.
What? This is an impressive quarter of football GWS.
Their hand through the contest has been brilliant, I reckon.
Well, we were all iffy after their performance last week, just nosing out St Kilda. And the first half here,
nothing
we thought that was disappointing as well. But this third quarter, I think this is what everyone's been expecting of them. We just need to see it on a more consistent basis. And the hands in here, Treloar, the dummy, and then to give it to Kelly, who just weighed up the option. I love Kelly's kicking. He doesn't try to punch it too hard. He just chips it into space.
Well, they've got to throw a loose man behind play now, Melbourne. Looks like Lumumba's gone back now, boys. Had to happen. You cannot afford to give. How many goals in the quarter? Is that seven? No, eight goals in the quarter. Yeah. You have to stem the tide.
Jamer. Tapped it down, but it's all going the Giants' way at the moment. It's in motion again. Cross, good man for a crisis, takes the mark. Dawes, Haynes got buffeted out of it, but he had the backup crew. Darting away there, Lockie Whitfield. Brings it into Callum Ward. He's been big in this quarter. They all have. Up to half forward. Palmer, Dunn, Scheel, crash the pack, effective. Kelly again with poise. Drives into the pocket for Cameron. He's a chance from there, Cameron. He's a big chance.
Oh, no.
They can't miss the Giants. When you're hot,
what?
You kick nine goals to nothing in the quarter.
Give me a spell.
Oh, you cannot do that. Look, you said Smith on the other side of the ground couldn't kick that banana kick and kick a goal. Well, Cameron, left footer. He had the right way to tumbling the ball because he's going to be pushed out of bound, out of bounds. You cannot. That is unbelievable football. They are just getting smashed around the ball at the moment.
He's done nothing wrong, Tom McDonald. No. Have a look at the reaction from Colin Garland. He just puts his hands on his face. Can't believe it.
Did you see that, boys? That is nine goals for the quarter. It is 10 unanswered goals. Suddenly the Giants lead by 26 points. Stunning turnaround.
That was his first touch for the quarter too, Cameron, as he gets another now.
Off to Ward. Stubs it out wide. Lovely hands, Cornelia, for Green. Can feed it back through the middle.
Oh, they are cutting him apart, Hutto. Sorry.
Well, their use by hand is so much more devastating than it was last week. They're forward handballs, aren't they? And they're causing all sorts of chaos here for the Demons.
Look at the chase here. The pressure.
Salem across to Lumumba. Trying to generate some run out of defence. He slams it forward. They're going to be outnumbered. Watts made a contest. That's a start. Core and Cornelio, who is everywhere at the moment. Out to Shaw as they scramble hard after the ball again. 2 minutes remaining in this incredible quarter of football. Wilson, plenty on the kick. Away from Cross. Still alive for Kelly. Had a big turn. So is this man, Devin Smith. The ball is over and out. Smith's kicked a couple in this quarter, so has McCarthy.
20 clearances to six.
Yep.
That is a smashing at any game at any time.
Give him the run.
In this quarter.
Saw McDonald and Cameron on screen there back in the goal square. Ward, just the instant gives, good pressure from the Demons when required.
And that's the problem with Lumumba playing loose in defence.
Yep.
Yeah, sure.
It frees up a giant, and that's Heath Shaw, and he plays that role very well.
Pat full. Beautifully weighted, both in terms of the right moment arriving and the depth on the kick.
Well, we saw what he did from the other boundary. Wonder what he's going to do on this side.
Well, this suits a lot better. But what would Paul Roos, what are you thinking, Jason? What they put a loose man behind play, but it's just they are being dominated, well, physically and mentally at the moment by this team.
Yeah, they can't win the footy.
Nah.
Which is a direct contrast to the first half. Whether the work rate's dropped off, I don't know. But they've found another gear, GWS.
It's a horror show for Demons fans, that's for sure. Jeremy Cameron, that's not going to be a goal. Too much time to think about it. Out on the full.
22 metres, marks out five.
We're down to the last 56 seconds.
Only had the eight possessions, Jeremy Cameron, for one goal, so he's been very quiet. I think Tom McDonald's done an excellent job, but doesn't need too many opportunities before that miracle goal moments ago.
Jack Watts. Got enough of it.
Hutto, just a quick one on the sub rule. Sub down here. Newton is coming back onto the ground, so looks like Brayshaw will go back off at the moment.
Yep. Thanks, Burns. So the last 25 seconds of a dramatic quarter.
He's done that a few times today. McDonald taking Cameron on.
Well, it takes it out wide for Kent. Needed to take the mark. If Melbourne were to score, unless his recovery had been sharper than it was. So it's Wilson now who goes forward, misses the target. Didn't really need to sneak one, which is not likely to happen. But sneak one before three-quarter time, at least give them something to go on with. The siren's going to sound.
Oh, well done, Callum Ward
again.
How good was that going back there?
Well, that was an incredible quarter of football, Jason. 9 unanswered goals. That's 10 in a row in this game from the Giants. It's scary.
I hope that's the real GWS that we're going to see from now on, Hutto. They could be anything.
Right now, they lead by 26 points, and Melbourne have a massive task in the last. Come back with us shortly here to Star Trek Oval.
The handball through the middle of the ground was absolutely brilliant.
Thank you, Moons. Last quarter then. What can Melbourne do early? The Giants were unbelievable in that third term, but can they sustain it? 26 points is the margin. There's still time for Melbourne. Brayshaw looks as if he's been activated. High ball. It could be a free to Hogan.
A couple of times he's grabbed the jumper, Phil Davis, and if it stretches, you give the umpire no out. If he sees that jumper pull, he's going to pay it every time.
Well, Hogan,
so he grabs a handful of jumper and he stretches it.
I don't think Hogan was ever going to look like marking the ball anyway.
He wasn't. So just need to do it.
It's soft.
Well, Jesse Hogan, he will know. He's kicked two goals. It's on very young shoulders, but if Melbourne is to be any chance, they need to take what is on offer early in this last quarter. It's really, he's a very big kick for Melbourne. Jesse Hogan. Bit of a stutter start, comes in, it's right-ish. Is it going to hang on? Sadly for Melbourne, it doesn't.
So Bernie Vince, we can just hear the umpire's mic there. Player 23, the player subbed out. Bernie Vince had the 13 possessions.
As they guide the ball along the wing.
An opportunity now for Angus Brayshaw, who's already picked up a couple of touches when he was on earlier as the sub when Newton was getting concussion tested.
Callum Ward goes as long as he can down to Cameron, Scully, Vandenberg. There was a fine line, but he just crossed it. 11-8-74, plays 7-7-49. Tom Scully.
You can see Lumumba there following Dylan Scheel as well after his outstanding first three quarters. They've decided to shut him down.
13 disposals today for Scully.
Beautiful.
Make that 14. Trelaw's got better and better as the game's gone on. So has this young man, Kelly, for sure. Gains an extra metre or two and a bullet kick for Toby Green.
That's a super pass.
What about the tap work, though, from Mumford? I think he has turned this game in the ruck. I think Jamar had him in the first half. That third quarter, he was just so dominant. His clearance work was just brilliant for a big man.
Thank you. March here.
Taking his time, which is a good sign.
21 disposals for Toby Green, just the behind as far as scoring is concerned. This would take them to 31 points. Never looked likely. Still alive though. Mumford again, flicked it out. And McDonald stumbles and takes it over and out. So let's see if we can gauge the urgency of Melbourne early in this final turn. Mumford, Shiel.
Holding his arm, Dylan Shiel.
Oh, off the ball.
Yep. Oh, I can see what the umpire saw. It was a line ball, but...
Well, we've just spoken about that, Lumumba going on to him in this fourth term.
He's on the mark.
Because he's just so dangerous. He's kicked two incredibly classy goals today. One was a long run with a few bounces on his natural left foot, and the other was on the non-dominant right foot. It just reeks of class, this young man.
So this for his third goal, Dylan Shiel. Wipes the brow, goes back, and punches it through for another goal. The goals are coming unabated for the Giants. It's now 31 points the difference, and that makes 11 in a row.
Well, it's just amazing, isn't it? And, oh, he did have his arm. That's where you'll get Lumumba just deep. He doesn't like being a defender at Collingwood. They had to push him up the ground at the end of his career. So just the unknown factor there. And good pick by the umpire. He did have a hold of his arm and didn't allow him to get to the contest. So free kick was there.
Disposals, three goals. I mean, what a great thing for your side. What a great advantage to have midfielders that kick goals, Jason. They're so important, aren't they?
Oh, he's exceptional. They've got a few of them that can do it.
Pat Fullen, Watts. And little minor win here for Melbourne with Watts. Angles the pass. Jones has had a quiet day.
As he was.
Doesn't get any better for him, but Watts will try again. But Griffin and the Giants have all the answers at the moment. As the ball is spread wide, and Shaw, who's also carried a big load today, takes the footy all the way to the wing. Feeds it through for Smith, but Cross puts an end to that. Jetta, Cross again, this time he's not mucking around. Ward, his former teammate, having to capture it at halfback. Bring it back to Shaw.
Due to leg speed across the ground, has really shown up Melbourne in the midfield. Melbourne have got some hard workers, but not a lot of players with natural speed.
Whitfield measures off the kick. Gets it right. Shiel held up. Turns onto the right. He's quite comfortable doing that.
This is too easy now.
Kelly gives it to Griffin. Plenty of height on it. Toby Green thought about flying. He stays down. Mumford protected it. Got it to Treloar. Cameron flew. They all fell down. Treloar went again.
Oh. Oh.
Scully's got a free.
Well, they're just feeling the pinch, aren't they, the Dees? They can't get a hold of the footy. They can't get a hold of the Giants that have got the footy. And they're just finding themselves under enormous pressure at every opportunity. And they actually, the Giants, pushed forward hard and had more numbers there than the Demons had defenders. So two on two flew, but there were a couple of Giants crummers at the foot of it all. And now we get to see Tom Scully line up and have a shot.
Not one of his great strengths. 26 goals in 88 matches. So
14 possessions for the game.
He's been solid. He's been solid, but he normally hasn't been good in this area. He is now.
Oh, he's kicked with confidence. It's contagious, Shorey.
Yeah.
He's put through another.
Well, this is just exceptional stuff. Oh. They're breaking all sorts of records. They'd kicked nine in a row at one point in time in 2014, but you're saying 12 now, Hutto. I'm hearing 11, but either way, they're breaking all sorts of records.
An
amazing turnaround, hasn't it?
Oh. Here's this man again, boys. It just is not working now. So I don't know if this goes to Mumford. You'd rather Dylan Shields got the ball. If Dylan Shiel gets the ball, he's saying, Nick off, Mummy, you're not getting the kick, but I think it has to go back to Mumford because that's where he ran through the mark.
Yep. Play out, please. So this for 13 unanswered goals.
Yeah, I should have gone with your stats rather than our producer, who's let me down badly again. But I won't burn Jack over that.
You don't throw anybody over under the bus at all, do you?
Mumford comes in, and even he can kick straight.
Oh, this is
amazing. Even the Ruckman are doing it here in Canberra.
Well, look, and as impressive and as amazing as this run has been for GWS, we're also going to have to consider the fallout for the D's off the back of this, because they showed a committed performance for half a game. Their first quarter was excellent. GWS started to get back into the game in the second term but didn't really convert. But this has been one-way traffic since half-time.
Now we can see here, there's Shea Mump, and there's, Jack Watts just ran straight through. You've got to know better than that. You have to run around the back and get your man. Well, it's very disappointing, Jay. But you're right, the second quarter, maybe we misunderstood. Although they had the lead of, 27 points. They still were 10 down inside 50s for the quarter, and they just didn't take their opportunities. Now, in the third quarter, they took their opportunities, all right.
It's been really disappointing that the Demons, at no stage, once GWS turned this game around, they haven't been able to find an answer.
No.
They haven't been able to restructure or re-strategise in any way, shape or form that has stopped GWS dominating, particularly around the stoppages.
Ball goes forward from Newton. And Treloar, all the effort still being shown. Vandenberg tried to step inside, tried a little too much. Shaw coming one way. Vandenberg hard the other. Demons have to show something to their coach in the last 10 or 15 minutes of this match. McCarthy worked his way to the front. Lumumba, Griffin, prospecting for the ball. Well done from Gallagher.
Look at the tackle, pressure.
Every tackle.
Oh, he's gone.
One after another. Should have been. Yeah, couldn't
see. Had the
sun in his eyes. Give him the benefit of the doubt. Treloar gets buffeted over.
But that's what Melbourne were doing to GWS in the first quarter, and now they've completely turned around. They've lifted their work rate. I'd love to have been a fly on the wall, whether it was quarter time or half time, to listen to Leon Cameron and what he said to these blokes, but boy, have they turned it around.
43 points.
Dominated.
Armchair ride for Green. Clean bowl down there. Canelio. Down had a little glance over the shoulder, saw the cross was with him. Uses him. The kick goes back to the wing. Big men fly. Little men stay down.
Ooh, oh,
Salem.
Boy.
Copped it from both sides. He's had a good day, Salem. 18 disposals, but he'd be feeling a bit sore for that.
Yeah, he's been far from Melbourne's worst. He was just the meat and the sandwich.
If you wanted two bits of bread, Ward and Mumford would not be your first choices if you were going to be the filling.
Well, the senior players for GWF have stood up, Foot stood up. They have been fantastic. They were questioned at halftime, I would think. And Cam Mooney said about, Callum Ward just going back with the flight of the ball on all occasions, not even worrying about his own safety. Mumford's lifted. Shield's been great all the time, and he's only a young player, but it's been very good. Who's sure? I think has been really good across halfback.
Let's try and get some run by sharing it around by hand. Vandenberg, a little bit of treatment.
Oh, nice bounce.
Yeah.
Nice bounce.
Fortuitous for Dawes, but hesitation, unfortunately, like the confidence, is spreading. Confidence the Giants have. Kick goes inside 50. It's going to come out again very smartly. Well done, Davis. Got it to core. He can chip through the middle. Toby Green.
Well, they got all the numbers.
Oh, good hands.
Got it across. Now they can dart through. The pace of Wilson. Saw off a couple of tackles and then kicked it beautifully.
He uses the ball well. We saw him kick a great goal. I think it might be in the second quarter that he kicked a beauty. In fact, third quarter, because he's down the other end. But he uses the ball well. He kicks low, penetrating kicks. And they are, they're a rabble at the moment, Melbourne. It's unfortunate to say. They started the season so well. First five quarters were excellent.
Canelio, 25 disposals, the most on the ground. This is for his second. And that'll do as well. The domination continues.
Well, I think we could see a GWS comeback potentially happening, but never thought it would turn into a percentage builder.
Well, you don't expect you're going to have a 9-goal quarter like they have here.
It's a cheeky gamble.
And the other thing is, too, we're seeing the talent that this side has brought together. And it has to show out sooner or later. The leg speed, to me, has been a massive difference. Their clearance work. And they've been tougher. They've tackled and pressured Melbourne into making mistakes and be fumbly. So well done to them. Well done to the coach.
That makes 14 consecutive goals for the Giants. Melbourne have got no answers at the moment. They've kicked four straight in this last quarter. To follow up their nine in the second. All this was when they didn't kick a goal at all in the first quarter. And only a couple in the second. Melbourne with an opportunity. A rare venture forward for them. Since halftime. Brayshaw held without it? No. Nathan Jones. He'll be hurting. Ball wandering around in the pocket. The fumbles continue. Newton ran around it. Got his bearings right. And finally he's able to kick truly. And put a stop to it.
Second goal for Ben Newton, and that's not a bad effort, given he spent time off for a concussion test, but too few and far between, unfortunately. He always looks composed when he gets the ball, Ben Newton. Beautiful kick of the footy. Good evasive skills, and then he straightened up. Straightened up nicely. I'd really like to see them finish with a little bit of a flurry or a little bit of momentum, at least, the D's.
Well, the last goal came in the second term, and finally, 14 minutes into the last, Melbourne's eighth is on the board. Frost did the ruck work. Salem had another possession. Bullocking work was pretty good, and it opened up the path, but Whitfield was able to find the ball. Ooh. Now they're getting in each other's way. Shield.
Oh, it was handball too.
Straight to Garland.
Yeah, cost him a goal.
Scrappy here for the Giants. Oh. And nothing's going the way of the D's at the moment.
Terrific Garlett, eight possessions, one goal, two. So could have been a bit better. Two goals a game is a good return for Jeff Garlett. Yeah, he's going to have his time when he kicks multiples.
Looked a lot more dangerous early in the game and has slowly drifted out of the contest.
Maybe fitness.
Here goes Wilson again. He gives good run, doesn't he?
Puts the pace on, ran his full measure.
Look at the kick.
And look what it created. Toby Green.
Yeah, he might be better off looking for a target. He struggled to make the distance from around the 50-metre arc earlier on. And when you're trying to kick right at your distance stretching point, it then compromises your accuracy.
Well, if knowing that, their teammates, they should have something set up here. You know, they're going to drop a player in that little spot, maybe out wide or into the pocket.
No one on the line here. If this falls short,
he's not going to kick the distance.
No, it's going to be an uncontested mark. That's really poor.
McDonald doesn't quite finish the job. Lumumba, who's toiled today with 18 disposals. Salem collects another. To Brayshaw, looking to link up, but he had no next link in the chain, sadly, and they've turned it straight over. And it's going to come back through Buck. Whitfield wasn't quite sure whether to go for it or not. Griffin gets a run at it, and it's going to be escorted. Not quite over from McDonald. Decides to keep it alive, and now the D's can have some run about them. Garlett's got four Giants around him, but he's got the advantage of the pace. Uses that to advantage. Kick to Dawes. Back to goal. Takes a long time. In fact, it's Jamar.
But Dawes pushing down long.
That's where he heads. And he was, would have thought, going to be too strong for Core. But Bug, opportunity, Brayshaw. Tackled, well restrained, and then thumped to the ground. Umpire lets it all keep going. Jones.
Got to get rid of it.
Threw it out.
The advantage paid almost accidentally. Shield kicked it out wide for Kelly. Now they can sort themselves out again off half-back.
Gee, that's a good kick.
He called him into that, didn't he?
I still think Tom McDonald's been one of Melbourne's best. He's done a terrific job on Jeremy Cameron.
Cameron marked the Treloar kick. Now, angles it out wide to half-forward.
A couple of loose in the defensive 50, the Ds. So they've got to be careful the way they use the footy.
Whitfield gaining in confidence. Toby Green, he can get the ball inside 50. He's had trouble kicking goals, and again,
slipped over.
This time his feet went from under him.
Well, he didn't want the set shot again, Hutto. He thought he'd find a different way to kick the goal.
Well, he just needs to find a way to get it to somebody else to have the shot, doesn't it? Because he's won the ball in that forward half so well.
He's done that his whole career, though. He hasn't been a great goal kicker, but he does win the ball. He finds it anywhere. Yeah, he's a man who you'd like to probably have 50-50 handball kick ratio, I think.
Back it goes to the wing again. Dawes. You're not getting out of there. That's holding the ball too.
Nearly up to 20 more tackles too. So it has been the pressure. They've been fantastic with their pressure. GWS.
Is the umpire getting things sorted out? Phil Davis, very proud of his troops today. Sends them to half forward. Big fly again. Tom McDonald certainly holds his head up high. Knocks it over the line and out of bounds. Jeremy Cameron, as you've mentioned before, just the one goal. 9 disposals, 4 marks.
He plays on. He thought, I'll run all the way in. It was a despairing attempt from Vandenberg, and then he slipped over trying to evade the two defenders. He just can't buy one, Toby Green.
Tight boys out there now.
I reckon they like playing with Toby Green, though, because it averaged 25.
Well, he's
had
25 today already. The trouble is his kicking's down at 45%.
It kills him, yeah.
Kick goes to half forward. Jamer, towering grab. They're one-on-one inside 50. Does he put it to the advantage of Hogan, Lumumba? Well, instead he goes for Jones versus Cornelia. Hogan comes at the right time. He too can't escape.
I'm glad Lumumba got rid of it. If he took one more step, Mummy would have put him in the next week. He was steaming in from the side. It's Jesse Hogan not happy
with the kick inside 50, I would think.
Out of there again through the impressive Treloar.
Oh, it could be a foot race here. A foot race.
It's faking.
Cameron wants it out in front. He just wants it kicked over the top out in front.
3 bounces, Reece Palmer. Quick assessment. Pokes it for Cameron, who dives, stumbles in, takes the mark. He is exhausted.
Well, he sprinted back about 120 metres for that. But Tom McDonald was within every step of the way.
You know what I'd be doing with Jeremy Cameron? I'd be showing him that speed that he had running forward when the ball's going to go into the forward line and say, that's how you've got to run when you've got to chase your man coming out the other way. That's what he's got to learn.
Where McDonald's been very good is every time Cameron's got the ball, he's forced him wide, he's forced him to the boundary, forced him deep into pockets. 15 gone. Positioning's been very good for a defender.
So Jeremy Cameron, just one goal. Takes himself out, improved the angle a little, but not enough. So we're looking at a 43-point margin here. So you saw the lead there. Now ball back in play, and they've turned it over again. Davis can set them up for more glory. Green was pushing and shoving. Jetta was a flyer, and he gets a ball. Has Salem to work with, but ignores him this time, hoping for Vandenberg. Core on the ground, shut down by Frost, who's appealing for holding the ball, but might just
get it. Spoke about GWS breaking some records, Hutto. This is their highest score in a half of footy, 81 points thus far in the second half. Their previous best had been 67, so they are really setting some standards.
Look at this place.
He's got some speed, just ran over. Oh, he doesn't think he did. He doesn't think he did.
That's Nathan Wilson we're talking about.
I love the way he takes the game.
He's given us a bit of entertainment when he's running, hasn't he?
It's not just his speed, it's his decision-making when he's come through the middle of the ground. Those two beautiful kicks inside 50. He's a beauty, this kid.
Moons is on board. The Wilson train. Throw in. Jamar. Free kick.
Yeah. Hey, Shane. Hold there.
Mumford's been magnificent today. Jamar good early. Mumford 11 disposals. All of them contested too, from contested possessions. Kent can't make the escape. Still full of adrenaline. That could have been holding the ball.
Should have been.
Newton. Try marking that. Dawes will. Davis does. And Kelly escapes to the outer side. 25th disposal, Josh Kelly. To Shaw.
Well, they had no spread in the first quarter, but gee, their second half spread's been the thing. Just that leg speed to get out the space, use each other.
Scully to half forward. Mumford straining every sinew to get every advantage he can for his team. Takes them inside 50.
It was a good old-fashioned shank, though, the kick. He's worked hard, Shane Mumford. He's been terrific again.
They sort themselves out nicely. A bit of system. Hogan takes it at half back. 99 to 56. Brayshaw, the Dawes. Haynes just nudged his way to the front. And Dawes,
well, that'll be a free kick against Dawes. Yeah, that'll be a free kick. Yeah, the rules. Can't interfere with the ball once it's gone over the boundary line. He's just punched it up into the crowd. It's okay to be frustrated, but you can't let it show, and certainly you can't let it affect the team by giving away free kicks.
Haynes can't believe his luck. Down the line, Mumford has to get there late. Be careful not to stand on and squash Jack Viney, who's in front of him.
It's not fun if you get caught under the ball when Mummy's coming in to attack it.
Well, I've been impressed with Nick Haynes too. Not just, we know he can play, but you know, he's had this injury. He's had this injury, and he's just seen the game out. You know, just the mental toughness to see it out.
Shield got an instinctive handball out to Ward.
He's been good.
He's gone down, Shield. He's hurt.
Uh-oh.
Jeremy Cameron got a boot to it. Oh! He's found the going tough today, Jeremy Cameron, against Tom McDonald. Here's Dylan Shield copping one.
It was an attempted tackle that almost looked like a little uppercut, didn't it?
Brayshaw. Good instincts there to get it to the... just to reduce the danger for his team, get it towards the line. There's some sore boys, but they won't be feeling a thing tonight. I think the Giants boys, they'll just be so pleased with how they've been able to turn this game around. Did not score a goal in the first quarter. Callum Ward. McCarthy. Done.
Did well to get a boot to it, McCarthy.
Got a call from Hogan in the middle, but instead he's hoping that Garlett might be able to take it. Heath Shaw's going to beat him with a punch, though. And Garlett kept at it. It's over and out. Heath Shaw, 22 disposals for the day. Cornelio has 26, the most on the ground. Green, Kelly and Shield all with 25. Treloar and Ward with 24. Griffin's up to 19. So that talented young midfield, which... we've talked about the depth that is there for them. All very influential in this performance today.
A bit worried about Chris Dawes coming into the team and their forward setup as in who, how many marking players. They haven't marked the ball well after since quarter time. So it just makes you very slow at ground level on the rebound too.
One bloke you mentioned earlier, Hogan. Hutto, was Jeremy Howe, who struggled to get into the contest.
Hasn't
only the 10
like
possessions. Doesn't look like they've swung him around too much either to try and find a way to get him to impose himself on the contest.
I reckon he's a definite forward. He's a definite forward,
I think,
Jason.
He can play anywhere, but just got to get him into the contest. He hasn't been able to do it himself.
Out to Griffin. They circle again. Griffin's going to get another crack at it. He's got a bit of a run-up here, Ryan Griffin. Doesn't have a shot for the high flyers. Cameron squeezed his way through, and it's over to you, Lockie Whitfield. Oh. He misses.
Well, Jeremy Howe, my argument with Jeremy Howe is we know he can run and jump and mark the ball. So if he's playing down in defence, how many times is he going to do that? And the other thing is he's up forward. If I'm the opposition coach, I'm worried about the matchup every time he's there, if they get the ball in deep. So I think he's a definite forward.
Brayshaw.
And they need a different type up there than what they've had.
Well, I think he can be very effective by playing up middle of the ground on the wing, somewhere like that as well. But
well, wing forward or something like that. Yeah. I don't think he's a defender as such.
Ward heaves it to full forward, almost got through the cracks. And Howe takes it over. 44 points the margin.
Now, see, if he was a midfielder having a bad day, he'd just kick it to himself to get the stat.
He might be smart enough to play down defence.
Good mark. Graham Hogan still showing us glimpses of what he's got to offer, and that's plenty. Two goals, two for him, 8 marks. Have you assessed Chris Dawes' day?
Oh, he's got a cramp in his hammy now. I think you can see he'll his hamstring shudder then.
Yeah, he's coming up for possession number 12, Chris Dawes. He competes, he covers ground, he'll get better. He's one of those that you need games under the belt.
Get the work into him.
I think he's going to be cramping up here.
Palmer, Cameron knows he's not going to mark this one, hoping he might get out the back to Devon Smith. Ever dangerous, minute 13 to go. Cameron now is back in pursuit again. In the shadows of the siren and the shadows of the stand, the Demons bring it out. And Daniel Cross, who's been a real workhorse for them, he was prominent early. Just haven't had enough since halftime. Jack Watts just ticked over the 300 disposals for the day, Melbourne.
Hasn't really got into it as much as you'd like either, Jack Watts. It's been a quiet day for him. Joel Patfield in particular early on made sure of that.
You see, Chris Dawes is a key position forward. He averages just over one goal a game. Now, he's played 100 games, 101 games, 102 today. You know, you've got to be better than that, I think, to have a keep your spot in the team, I would think.
Ryan Griffin really starting to rack them up now. Just toying with them here. 16 seconds to go, and the countdown is on to the Giants' second ever win here in Canberra. They didn't kick a goal in the first quarter, but when they came with a rush, an avalanche of goals, and the Giants have made a big statement here. We've seen what is to come, and it might just be scary for the other teams in the competition. The Giants win by 45 points, an incredible comeback. They have smashed the Demons, 15-11-101 to 8-8-56.
Oh, what a great turnaround from quarter time when they were really under the pump. 24 points down at quarter time, 27 down at half time. But their second quarter was very good. They had inside 50s, 10 more for the quarter. Just couldn't score. But gee, that third quarter to kick the nine goals to nothing. They only kicked a couple of points, 3 points Melbourne. That was the quarter, and it just showed the ability this group's got as a running, hard unit, and their tackling, their pressure for young players. They tackled and pressured to make Melbourne fumble and turn the ball over. Magnificent win to GWS.
Yeah, look, there's two stories coming out of this one. There's no doubt about that. I think Cam Mooney's tracked down Stephen Canelio. Might head down onto the ground. Moons.
Thanks, Jay. Stephen, it was a really poor start from you guys. You couldn't kick a goal in the first quarter. Only two.